Hello everyone, welcome back to another week of Die Party Nightcity, a Cyberpunk 2020 adventure. I'm sorry in advance if things sound a little fucked up, it's because I'm on my new PC and audio is literally the most annoying thing in the world to try and get right. So, we're just gonna forge ahead and see what happens, huh? Let me go around and introduce everyone who will be playing with us tonight. Up first, we have Mr. AP Gaming Real playing Dante Fierro. How you doing, sir?
I am fine. How are you?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. What about you, Dave? Are you also fine?
Is this like one of those trick robot questions? Like, what's going on?
How to Human 101.
Yes, I am good. Thank you for asking.
Excellent. That's good to hear.
Quick, somebody throw a logic paradox at him. This statement is false.
All right. I mean,
that's obviously ridiculous.
Yeah, it's true. No one believes in logic. That was your main problem right there.
You know what? Let me tell you something about logic. I started watching Macross the Robotech Saga today on Netflix, like the first 5 episodes. Why? I've seen a lot of bad anime in my time.
Yeah.
It is the worst anime I've ever seen. And not because it's poorly animated, because it's not. It's because the people in it make, if they're offered a choice, they continually make the worst fucking choice.
Is it are we talking?
No. They fly a giant spaceship next to the planet, and the captain's like, activate the hyperdrive. And someone's like, we've never activated the hyperdrive before. Are you sure it's safe? And isn't that against regulations? He's like, yes, it's against regulations. No, I'm not sure it's safe. They fucking evaporate an island, kill millions of people, and put several aircraft carriers in orbit above Pluto. And he's like, oh God, what have I done with my life?
Give him a break. It was probably his first TTRPG.
I was going to ask if it's Prometheus levels of dumb, but yeah.
Yeah. Instead of running sideways when the rotating object is coming at you, you try to get right in that little groove.
I still clap for the only sensible decision in fucking Prometheus, which is when she fucking flamethrowered that dude. It was just like, oh my God, somebody did something not stupid. And then spent the rest of the film shouting in rage. Anyway, sorry.
I mean, if everyone did everything smart in these things, they wouldn't have stories, right?
No. There's, oh, shit going wrong. And then there's, I'm going to wrestle an alien snake.
Let me give you another example real quick, Henley. A guy trapped in a spaceship is like, there's a giant tuna fish from the aircraft carriers floating outside. My civilian aircraft gear will protect me from deep space. I'm going to go get that tuna fish and bring it back inside. Pro tip, he nearly freezes to death instantly.
I have so many questions.
So bad.
Guys, we should do a movie night and watch Macross, I think.
Oh my God.
I'm down. I'm definitely down.
I think I need to get very drunk and shout at anime.
Speaking about deep space tuna fish, let's go on over to the local tuna fish of the show, Mr. Typical GM. How you doing, sir?
I'm not sure how I feel about that.
I mean, I'm not sure how anyone feels about that.
Speaking of getting drunk and watching bad anime, like that would have been right on target. Anyways, I'm super tired. We've been packing and cleaning, and we went out to a new lot today to compare it to the one we'd already decided upon. So a lot of stuff going into building.
So what exactly do you look at in an open lot when it comes? Did you look at it and you're like, yeah, I could see my house here? Or do you go there and you'd be like,
it's the neighbors so it comes seem down to
yeah,
a lot of different factors, how buildable it is. So if it has like a steep incline, steep decline, a lot of rocks.
Groundwater or where do you live?
Alabama? But I mean, that's expensive. Like, let's say I need to level a lot out, right? Or I need to, like, the lot that I'm going to build on is very thickly wooded, so we're going to have to spend about $2,000 just to bulldoze and clear and level it. But there are much less buildable lots. We have to spend closer to, like, $5,000 or $6,000 to bring in, fill dirt, and push over trees and get them trucked out and all that kind of stuff. So,
unfortunate fire accident.
Right.
You know. Controlled explosion.
But yeah,
so just, faster with a chainsaw.
Just Einar those things right out of the ground, man. tank mines.
The problem is, so like, so that's the kind of stuff you look for, as well as is the lot big enough for you to build the house plan you want. What natural obstacles you're going to have? Are you going to be able to angle the house in a way that's going to make it appealing from the curb? All that kind of stuff. So.
Plus, you know. If I'm gonna put my bedroom windows against the fucking morning sun, because if you do that, you're a crazy person. So you know.
You can buy blackout curtains. They're pretty cheap.
Even with blackout curtains, it's still look. Our bedroom window is like fucking just like, you know, first thing in the morning, bang! And even with blackout curtains, it's still creeping around the edges, and you're like, fuck off, no.
Someone decided somewhere that it'd be a good idea to make this window face the morning sun. And you're like, what if I want to sleep in that room? And they're like, I'm never going to sleep in that room. First thing you did when you moved into that house, you put your fucking bed there. I guarantee it.
Yep.
How you doing, Fuzzy? What's up?
Yeah, not bad. I had a fish tank emergency this week. Because I've just been setting up my new fish, my old fish tank. And then I had it set up for like 2 weeks and just put some shrimp in. It was all going really nicely. And then it fucking sprang a leak and like cracked down the side. And it was just like, oh, that's not good then.
Is that so like a duct tape thing? Like, how do you deal with that?
It was temporarily duct taped. But basically, I had to do an emergency fundraiser. Just be like, please help me buy a new fish tank because my shrimp will die. And I like them. So now I actually pretty fucking sweet fish tank.
Man, being a Twitch streamer professionally is like the weirdest thing ever. See, if it was me, I'd be like, okay, I'll just use my savings to fix this. And you're just like, fuck it, man, I'll just stream for like 28 hours and buy myself a fish tank.
It's not that I'm not exactly, look, basically I break even. So if I have any untoward expenses, I'm just like, spare some change, my lord! And that's basically how I live.
Do you enjoy my old lady sound? I can do it for 20
hello, love, I'll swap your worst original for 20 quid. It's an original one. Look, pocket fluff and everything.
Gross! Aside from that, though, you been playing anything new? You been hitting up that Mafia 3?
No, I'm not. It's I'm sure it's good, but it's like
what about
I'm not
that,
excited about.
What about that Sunless Sea expansion? You hitting that up?
That comes out tomorrow.
I already got a key for it. They actually emailed me. They're like, hey, yo, you want a key? And I'm like, yeah.
Yeah. I've been basically because I've been talking to Han-chan about it for a while, so I'm just like, so yeah, I think tomorrow, whenever the fucking embargo is up.
Okay. She didn't actually say anything about an embargo. Maybe that was her mistake. Maybe I should call a bluff on that and just stream it.
Yeah, I can tell you exactly when the embargo is, but not right now because it's in an email somewhere. Ah. But yeah, I got my key and I'm just like, yes, Submariner, yes.
It's going to be good. I'd like to see what's under that water.
Probably horrible Cthulhoid monstrosities, angry monkeys, squid.
You're probably just going to read about it. It's not going to be like, oh, look, there's the thing. It's like, nope. Imagine a being of unlimited eyes, and you're just like,
Like, I guess I could see down there. But think about all the treasure you've lost is all down at the bottom of there.
Eh. Maybe.
It's never treasure. It's never treasure. It's always monkeys that want to eat your soul.
All those gems from, like, all those coins from Pirates of the Caribbean that turn you into skeleton dudes.
Oh, yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah.
Fail Better are quite good at...
I was about to say, I think speaking about skeleton dudes, let's go over to our resident skeleton dude. You're ready for Movember, I see. Nice mustache.
Yeah, I always got it going.
Every member is Movember. No, that doesn't.
Every member? Giggity.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah. I'm ready for the cold winter. I can curl up in my mustache for warmth.
Yeah.
Like a cocoon.
Like a cocoon. Yeah. Other than that, I'm ready for some cyberpunking.
Should be good.
I'm excited for, you know, upcoming torture scenes. that should be involved.
Oh, yeah, shit, we left on that. Man, I wish Chip was here. So yeah, Chip isn't here because he's facing natural disasters, so... You know.
Yeah, he's probably trying to swim west at the moment.
A real role player would have just bought a Morse code set and communicated with us through that.
A real role player would have tied himself to the pipes that go underground so that he could see inside of the tornado.
I can imagine Chip easily with
a hurricane, not a tornado.
Whatever, it's the same shit.
Like a satellite backpack nav, like, you know.
Yeah.
You know, I've discussed this before, so I just want to keep bringing up scenes from Snow Crash.
Good.
Amazing cyberpunk novel.
I like Snow Crash.
I wanna preface this by saying we've seen how Chip prepares to play World of Warcraft with several dozen energy drinks. I assume he's got 2 or 3 PCs with a bunch of monitors and probably more than one computer. So if he really wanted to survive the weather, he would have just gotten a floating boat and then dunked his streaming PCs in that and used the heat exhaust to push the boat. Yeah. Just like they did in
Turbine,
where they used the nuclear-powered Gatling gun to jet themselves across the ocean.
That sounds like someone had a game of Cyberpunk and then wrote a book about
ripping people to pieces.
I mean, yeah, they take out, I think, several...
It's Snow Crash where the protagonist is called Hero
Protagonist. Hero Protagonist,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Yes,
yeah, no, his name is Hero, H-I-R-O, protagonist. What? It took me like I'm there like halfway through the book going...
They use a fucking Zodiac and a Gatling gun to fight an aircraft carrier.
Oh my god, I need to read this book. By the way, yeah, I'm glad you said floating boat, because your story would have not...
Are several boats that don't float during the middle of that story.
You didn't let me finish my sweet pun. I was about to say, your story would have been taking on water if you hadn't.
Oh, wow, get out.
I feel slightly nauseous. I can't work at least.
Woo! Got him. Alright, so I'm assuming, Virgil, you would like to do the honors of receiving free IP.
Oh, of course I would, Dave. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
So, I hid in a vent and ate some tacos.
I love how Virgil, arguably the least physically powerful character, has the most IP.
Yeah. You know what I also like? That if this was a TV show like Lost, he would be the guy that's like previously on Nightcity, like every time.
On Lost.
But he'd be like,
I'm the narrator.
Previously on Nightcity. Like,
yeah.
And it turns out that he's telling the story from his deathbed in 45 years.
Just one last true science fact about Lost. The guy that says that is the CEO of the company that greenlit the Lost pilot, and he was fired for doing that because they were like, Lost is never going to be a big show. This is dumb. And so when it became a big show, they were like, well, we should probably throw him a bone and let him be the narrator.
Wow.
Well, that's nice.
I'm surprised he accepted that job. I really need money. Anyway,
so
what happened last week, Mr. Virgil?
Last week, last time, Astrid and Dante had a little talk about the friction at work between Einar and herself.
Or the lack thereof.
And he suggested maybe she heat things up.
Sexually.
Also,
not exactly what I said.
They were
fucking friendly.
Can you fuck him into the friend zone? Is that a thing you can do?
Not what I said.
Totally.
Yeah.
Okay.
They were you know, worried about Band, you know, showing some real concern because they're such good friends of Band. And lined up some appointments to see a psychiatrist of the company.
Oh, maybe.
A child psychologist, actually.
Yeah. A specialist. Someone good with kids, you said. So, we celebrated with tacos on the roof. We were just getting our taco on. Oh, I remember I was, like, poking into Astrid's, like, history, and she was like, yeah, don't fucking ask. And I was like, all right, I'll be off. And then someone tried to kill Weston.
Yes.
Shots rang out. We jumped in the VTOL. We headed over to where the fuckers were.
Well,
I didn't.
We headed. Yeah, you. Yeah. You...
I headed a vent. Let's be clear. What was really going on? Chip like kind of got cover and then set up, or Weston rather set up. The others took the VTOL over. He dropped. Dante dropped off our brave warriors. Astrid and Einar on the roof. There was an ensuing.
I think Astrid was more worried than brave. She's like, why?
Our worried and brave warriors. There was like an epic chase down the stairs, dodging like traps, blowing up one floor to jump down to the other to tackle a guy. Meanwhile, Dante flies the VTOL down to the front to lock them up and make sure they can't escape. I heroically climb out of the vent and make a phone call and get routed to another country. Actually, no one in the building that day.
It was taco day.
Yeah. So with one apprehended suspect, another one runs out the front door to find not escape, but Dante, the arrow, launching fucking grenades at him. He quickly said, please don't grenade me in the face. I'll do whatever you want. I think that was about the end.
Sounds about right. Yeah. And then you captured some dudes and you brought them back. It was just the one dude, right?
Yeah, the tacos were actually
The unconscious dude that I snogged unconscious, and then did you capture the other guy as well?
Oh, you did.
Yeah, you smooched him at the end.
Yeah.
That's right. You got
I remember because Dante was like,
because there was the one up the top that I smooched.
Yeah.
And then there was we carried him out, and then there's the other guy as well.
Yeah, you smooched him.
So yep. Two guys.
Yeah, so we got two POWs.
The amount of unconscious lipstick stained guys is important.
Yes.
And Einar had like taco hand problems the whole day.
I remember. So Arthur, you had a plan that you wanted to go over.
I do. So Dante starts by sending a quick text message wink to Einar that we've already discussed off stream. And then has Weston stay on the roof to cover us and make sure that no other baddies are coming. And then he turns to everybody and says, all right, Astrid, I want you to interrogate that one. Einar, interrogate that one. Band, take their equipment apart. Tell me what you can about it.
Okay.
Ooh, I wonder how much I would know about it.
I just see Ben
you see Christmas.
I'm like, oh, this one's real heavy, boss.
You are my tech specialist.
Oh, this one's even heavier.
All I'm saying is figure out if it's a gun or a cyber limb or a helmet. If you can do better than that, that's great. I just generally expect the lowest level of proficiency from you at this point.
You know what I'm imagining?
Okay, I have basic tech pretty...
You know what I'm imagining? You know that Jurassic Park scene before the T-Rex hits and the kid's looking through the X-ray goggles? And the guy's like, how heavy is that? And he's like, pretty heavy. He's like, it's expensive. Put it down.
That's totally, yeah.
heavy,
then it's expensive.
Put it down. All right.
Basic tech roll? Will that work?
Let's start off with some interesting stuff before you get into the techno babble. Let's start off with Einar and his interrogation technique. So I assume that you've separated and isolated these people.
Yeah, it's pretty standard military procedure. When you take prisoners, you separate them. You separate the officers from the enlisted.
Ooh, I actually have skills in interrogation.
So we'll do that. And do we still have access to that warehouse downtown or whatever?
Sure, yeah.
So I'm gonna take that guy there. Like I imagine this in my mind.
I'm literally standing there, like preparing a room for you to interrogate somebody, and you're lugging him to the cargo elevator, and I'm just like, what?
What I'm gonna do?
It's gonna get really fucking messy.
I know. If I may,
I actually tried to call in to inform that there was something fishy going on. There's no one in the building here. I mean,
across the other building we just
came. We could go across the street. Make a right.
Why don't you do it here? We throw dead bodies off the roof all the time. Nobody's gonna care.
True.
I'm going to take Astrid and Dante to the side and just it would be best if at least one of them had the hope of surviving this.
May I suggest good cop, bad cop? It's a classic.
I think that's best suited to your skill set, Astrid.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps Dante, you could offer him gainful employment or some sort of financial reward. This one, I'm going to jerk the thumb back towards the one guy. He will not make it out alive. But he doesn't know that yet.
You know, I thought there would be more of a plan to, like, get information from one and then go to the other and say his buddy turned and ratted him out and then drop some information and he'd be like, oh, shit.
Yes.
I better rat out my buddy before he tells too much more information. I want to cut a deal. Something like
you catch, that. Yes, you catch more flies with honey. That,
also, I'm
brutalizing,
not communication room. That's ridiculous.
Yes, brutalizing people does not get good information. It just makes them say anything to make the pain stop.
Well, actually, brutalizing people has done pretty well on getting us information so far. But I suspect these folks are a bit more trained.
It is a thing. Let me work on them both first.
Why don't we make this a competition? Each of you can interrogate however you want in whatever way, and whoever comes back with the best information gets to do whatever they want with their captive.
Very well, sir.
I want to murder him. I want to spare him, but I want to tickle him as well.
I'm already going to do everything I want to my captive.
Well then, no problem agreeing to this then.
Yes, sir, of course.
Alright.
Yeah, so we should probably take Astrid first, because I am going to take this guy all the way down to the warehouse. 100%. I'm not doing
this. Don't want the other guy hearing the screams.
It's the only place where we have a hydraulic press.
I really love the idea that as you drive him to the next building, you're on a moped for some reason. With him
like I'm singing downtown.
And you're listening to downtown.
You don't more like no beach, boy.
I was thinking more like Weekend. I was thinking more like Weekends at Bernie's, and he's in like the passenger seat, and you put sunglasses on him so that you can use the multi-person
Weekend
lane.
At Bernie's.
Yeah. So you can use the carpool lane, so you can get there faster.
He's got his hands like around his waist, but they're just like handcuffed there, so he doesn't fall off.
You got a little rope around, like, around his neck so that, like, you know, if somebody, you guys are right there? Yes!
Looking around. Pulling on
I don't think anyone's going to stop and question.
No, we're just going with the whimsy.
Oh, yeah, I got you. So let's do Astrid first, and then we'll do...
All right. Okay, so Astrid, give me an idea of how you... Like, do you put a single light in the room? Are you, like, how...
Oh, no. It's pleasant... Pleasant, sort of. Basically, it's going to be like
he wakes
like,
up in a bubble bath, and he's like, "What the fuck?"
No. But it's just going to be like pleasant sofa. Well, actually, no. Like desk, sort of like two chairs across from a desk, sort of thing. I'm going to be doing the full sexy secretary thing with just a hint of cleavage, professional but sexy.
cleavage. Okay.
Just a touch. Just when you bend over, there's like, oh, boobs. How did those get here? You know that kind of just
Okay.
Of shit. And I'll sort of like, just walking in, just like, would you like a coffee? There you go. And it's sort of like, just basically start by going.
Your interrogator will be here with you momentarily, but before that happens.
Accident.
He's stuck on the highway.
No, I'll be like, I just need to take a few details from you. And, can you just, yes. Okay. That kind of shit. And also using the pheromones, because why not?
Sure. I mean, using the pheromones. You would generally have a very easy time of this. Let me just pull up your character sheet.
I have 5 in interrogation.
Yeah, I'm just going to...
I have 3.
Seems good cop, bad cop, bitch! Now, these... Hey, I suggested combining, you know, working together.
I would say that her higher skill might result from, like, you eventually kill the person faster than she would. So there's, like, a higher chance that your person's dead before they die.
I feel like the thing that maybe is not being...
See, what would have worked better, in my opinion, is if, like, you roughed him up, and then I would have come in and just be like, oh, this is, I'm terribly sorry. And, you know, good cop, bad cop.
I mean, sure, I get the good cop, bad cop, which, like, there's nothing that
Einar doesn't,
Dante's approval.
We need to encourage an air of corporate competition between our employees. I've not been feeling enough. What is it that it's called in Japan? Zanshin? Warrior, corporate warrior spirit?
Oh, I've got loads of like that. That's
I don't feel like that's crazy talk. Zanshin, definition. A state of awareness and relaxed alertness. All right, that's definitely not it. But yeah, I feel like maybe Dante's been reading some sort of like Japanese.
If you make us sing the company song, I am fucking out, all right?
I imagine that you read a lot of these books while waiting for like Michael Knight or something like that in Arasaka. They just have them as like coffee table books and you just like...
Oh yeah, no, I've been studying up on Arasaka ever since they've been trying to murder me for weeks. They're really big on like this corporate competition thing. And so I'm fully behind this, even if it stabs us in the butt slightly. I feel like...
Oh yeah!
Interrogating both of them.
Dear
to death,
employees,
we'll work out in our favor one
we
way
have
another.
Instituted a new regime where two of our higher managers will compete against each other in a friendly competition, where the winner will receive a slight bonus check and the loser will lose his life.
No, it'd be like American Gladiators, where they go at each other with giant sticks until one of them fell into a ball pit.
That works. That sounds-
That's my promotion! Quap! Quap!
we've got to be on the wobbly pads. Just...
Alright, so... Like okay, it. So what is your
so,
what is
so
your
what's
aim?
The plan? Bad cop, kid cop?
You wait for this guy to work up?
Oh, mate?
God. Yeah.
So you're waiting for this guy to wake up, yeah?
Yeah. Well, I'll be sort of like... If he wakes up, I'll be there gently dabbing his face.
Oh, he seems to be sweating. Okay. Yeah, so he wakes up and he like, do you have him tied? Like, what are you doing? What's that? Handcuffed?
You're like, I'm dabbing his face, but he's also hog-tied and on his chest.
I like the idea that you've got it, like, both of you have him, like, chained up to something. One is chained to the bed and the other one's chained to a rusty pipe in the fucking basement.
A little press in the automotive factory or whatever that we
no,
have.
I'd say, yeah, he's handcuffed to the chair just because he is, you know, capable of killing me probably so bad. So yeah, handcuffed to the chair, but I'll just be like, sort of like, ooh, you know.
And at the same time, Aina, let's get your setup. Where's this guy? In this place that you have, what's he look
as
like?
As mentioned, we are in the warehouse, so I would imagine. Remember, we already did one torture scene here.
Yeah.
So I feel like there's already going to be like the blood stains on the floor and
like a finger.
Yeah, the air of despair and hopelessness that he's.
There's like there's
a pipe with some chunks of hair on it.
Yeah, there's like 10 fingernails just like scattered about.
Oh,
yeah.
So yeah,
I am going to have him.
No. 11 fingernails.
I'm going to have him manacled and suspended from the hydraulic press or the hydraulic whatever lift from the automotive factory. Probably about like, you know, just so his feet are just off the ground. Like if he extends his toes, he can just barely make contact, but not enough to actually
sustain
relieve
weight.
The strain.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so I imagine that like we get like a camera scene of both of these dudes like startling awake at the same time. Except one has got a face full of boobs and the other one's, I don't know, Einar's prancing around with like a fucking exposed cabling that's electrically charged. Like, what's going on there?
When he wakes up, Einar will be reading a book.
Okay.
Oh god, that's scarier.
Like a big, like large print history book.
Oh,
The Art of War.
Big enough for dummies.
Yeah, big enough to really hurt if you threw it at him, right?
You know, if I punch you through this book, it doesn't leave any marks.
How to Throw Really Heavy Objects, Volume 1.
It's actually a treatise on the history of early 1800s America.
Oh, so War and Peace.
Not quite. You'll see. I have a plan. I'm going somewhere with this.
All right, so, Ina, what do you do first? The guy is awake now.
Is the guy waking up?
Yeah, he's startled awake. Like, he's just sort of, like, snapped into a consciousness. And the first thing that he does is he just looks around, starts sweating, like, almost instantly, and he just starts screaming out in frustration. For him, it's a little case of, like, okay, my body is in extreme pain.
Sure, excruciating pain. Could it be a thing that before I came here, I picked up, like, a pair of, like, wire-rimmed reading glasses? I just imagine Einar, like, with his helmet off, in his metal gear, with, like, a pair of reading, like, uncharacteristic reading glasses and this large print history.
I like that you're sitting there like this, and you just, like, you lick your metal gear thumbs, exactly. And you just flick the page.
the book's upside down.
Okay, is Einar, like, stop at, like, a gas station and buy these just for, like, effect?
Yeah.
Or is it, like, yeah, okay.
Like, yeah, I like the idea that you drove up to this gas station, there's, like, just no one there. The sound of you walking into the door goes, I was like, you know, like, and then, like, this big...
What fucking gas station where's, like...
I mean, I'm still covered in, like, char marks and soot from blowing a hole in the floor.
And there's, like, some, like, unconscious guy in your car wearing sunglasses in the passenger seat. And the guy's just, like, do you need any...
So he starts screaming. I'm going to hit him. Like, I'm going to close the book and, like, take off the glasses, put him down really carefully, and walk up and, like, two-hand the book and just hit him across the face with it.
All right. So, yeah. And then at the same time, Astrid, what are you doing?
I'll just be like, kid, how do you feel now? Are you okay?
He's like,
took a little knock there.
What happened? Where am I?
Oh, you're somewhere safe. But we need to ask you some questions.
He starts to, like, do that thing where, like, he realizes he's tied up, so he starts to strain against his restraints. Like, he's just like...
I'll sort of place my hand on his lap, sort of, like, close-ish to his crotch, just be like, settle down now, it's okay, don't worry. Nobody's gonna hurt you here.
Can we get some kind of luck roll to see if he's into this kind of thing?
Yeah, absolutely. Ashley, give us a luck roll.
My favorite is when they're like, the restraints are for your safety.
Yeah, no, he's he just sort of like, he looks up at you and he just like, that won't work on me. And then he just starts to like, I don't know, like Jimmy, like, he starts to do something with the back of his hand. So.
Feel like I'm watching a Metal Gear
song. Like shimming around a little bit.
Yeah, like moving the chair around, you know? Like,
he's like, what you gonna do? What am I gonna do?
That won't work. I've been trained to resist chemical interrogation.
Your feminine woes won't work on me. Yeah, so...
I'm totally married and love my wife.
So yeah, I know, you just beat this man in the face with a book.
No, just once. Like, not even as hard as I possibly can.
Yeah,
just...
we're coming back in the scene.
Only a little bit of a broken jaw.
He's like, just slightly down from as hard as I possibly can.
I'm going to hit him with the book, and I'm going to be like, Dante told me that education is important, and sometimes it's difficult. I can see he's correct. I'm just going to throw the book behind me. Like, the lesson here is don't scream. I have a little tinnitus. I've shot too many explosions, a little bit of hearing damage. So the pitch of your scream is very, very painful. And I don't want this to have to be as terrible as you're imagining it could be. All of the burning and electrocution, the castration, the flaying, all the things that you are just running through your brain right now. I don't want to have to do them. But if you keep screaming, I have no choice. Dante made it very clear I have to get information from you before Astrid gets it from your friend.
Okay.
Wouldn't it be fun if we, and like, I'm just gonna put my hand like around his shoulder and like lean on him so it pulls even more on his like already straining chest and back.
Yeah.
Like, wouldn't it be so great if we could win this little competition together? You and me, we could be friends. We could talk about this at our barbecues. If we have children one day, if I don't cut your penis off, then then we could be sitting around a bonfire somewhere out in the countryside, having roasted whatever meat your people eat, and talking about this and laughing about it. And it would be so great. Don't you think so?
He just sort of like, maybe there's a sound of like the chains like just being taut or whatever,
just rattling a little bit.
Yeah, just rattling a little bit. And he just sort of just looks down at you, and he's just like, he doesn't really say anything. Maybe you hear him gulp or whatever, but like. He doesn't say anything.
This is not what it was cut out to be. Astrid told me to be nice and then to be bad, but I'd rather just be bad in the beginning instead of having to be nice. So I guess that's what they're going to have to do. You made me do, I'm going to put my hand in his face. You made me do this.
All right.
So I didn't want this.
So we swap over to Astrid. Astrid, the guy is staring you down, essentially. What are you doing?
In that case, I'll be like, fair enough then. I'll perch myself on the corner of the desk and I'm just like, well now, there are two, well, possibly three or four ways this could go. Now, a friend of mine is currently working on your little compatriot, and I really think you should talk to me rather than him, because my friend is, how can I put it? Dangerously psychotic. Yes, that's the word. So perhaps if you give me some, you know, just give me some details, something to work with, and perhaps I can save you from dismemberment. What do you say? What was your name, by the way?
He just,
I'm Astrid. It's lovely to meet you.
So you've probably seen this before. There is a steely eye that both of them actually have. So maybe we get like a scene by scene, like a camera, a picture in picture, of both these gentlemen looking at you, and they've got this look in their eye. You know, it's kind of like this in anime, it would be like a shimmer. Or like in,
do they have the eye of the tiger?
Yeah, it'd be like, you know, the light sort of reflects off their eye a little bit, and they both look at you and they say, almost at the same time,
Dra.
they both say at the same time, one says, yours, Einar says, John Merkin's corporal specialist, Biotechnica, and yours, Astrid says, Sammy Greenhouse, corporal specialist, Biotechnica.
Sammy, oh, lovely to meet you.
And they both just very astutely just sort of stare you down after saying that.
So, Sammy, I have a very important question to ask you. Would you like a cup of coffee? Tea? Water?
Yeah, he's continuing to stare at you. He doesn't break eye contact, and he doesn't say anything else.
It's been so long since I've done this, I almost forget how to do it. Well, Sammy, I'm going to sort of like walk around behind him and sort of whisper in his ear and just be like, Sammy, Sammy, Sammy. Now, I know they've told you that resisting torture is a good thing, and but that really, that's okay, because I won't torture you. But really, what are you gaining from this?
At the same time, we swap over to Aina. Aina, what are you doing?
I am pulling this dude's pants down.
Now, normally it would be Astrid doing that. My God. Oh,
yeah. I would have put my money on the Astrid getting there before you, but...
Yeah.
All right, yeah, so you take down his flak pants, I guess, is what he's wearing.
Whatever he's wearing. I'll pull him down and be like, usually my associate would be doing this. Lucky.
Yeah, he's like eyes forward at all times with you, I know. Okay, he's not even like looking at you. Like
so as I do this, I'm gonna pull out one of my white phosphorus grenades and unscrew the cap and begin to pour a little bit out into a small basin and start mixing into a nice fine paste.
Oh shit.
Oh no.
Okay. Alright, so are you saying anything to him while doing this? Or?
No, he's not looking at me, so yeah. I am very passive-aggressively doing this. Like, as I've yanked his trousers down, he's sort of flapping there in the wind.
Wow, super severe passive-aggressive actions there.
Like, and probably, like, muttering to myself, like, Dante thinks Astrid will win? I don't think so.
Alright, so let's swap back over to Astrid. Astrid, you know, he's not, Sammy is not saying anything to you whatsoever. And, right, you know, if you're behind him whispering in his ear, his eyes and head don't deviate from straightforward either, so.
That's fine. I'll just sort of start, like, stroking his jawline and things and just sort of whispering in his ear and just being like, you know, just trying to sort of, like, get under his skin a little bit, just being like, so, tell me, do you have a girlfriend? Boyfriend, maybe? Both? Hmm. I mean, you want to see them again, right? I mean, that's... I just don't see how this job is worth that much to you. We could offer you employment here. I mean, let's face it, it's better than death, right? Kids? You look like you've got kids. You've got that... worried fur, sort of like worried fur. Actually, did he have a wallet on him or anything?
Of course not.
You can ask, you can hope, right?
At best, he's got dog tags. At best.
He's got his sniper business card.
I'm going to start deploying the pheromones a bit as well. And
okay. Yeah. So, as stated before, the pheromones are a thing that you sort of have to apply to his skin. But you have no problem achieving...
Yeah, I'm like rubbing my... You know, I'm just sort of gently sort of like, you know, stroking him and... Well, I thought they were like airborne, because you can just...
They are, but you have to be with like reasonably close.
Yeah, well, I'm whispering in his fucking ear. That's close enough.
Yeah. So, yeah. So the pheromones give you a +2 to seduction check, but as we rolled before, your seduction check's actually going to be pretty hard due to his... sexual orientation.
Yeah, he's not into being tied up and
Which is fair enough.
Yeah.
Sure.
So what would you like to do now that you've applied pheromones to this gentleman?
Would it give me any bonus to the interrogation? Like would it make him any more positive, or would I need to seduce him then try and apply that to the interrogation?
So the pheromones they're mostly used for seduction. So if you wish to make any seduction checks, you get a +2 to it, but, it doesn't make him, and if he was sexually,
receptive
would be the right word. Yes. To your advances, then it definitely helps sway his mood. But, the difference between this guy and someone on the street is
he's had training to resist.
He's had training, and he's also not interested sexually with it to women. So, as per your luck roll. So, generally speaking, you're going to be rolling at a negative anyway when it comes to seduction, but your pheromones offset that, essentially. So you won't be rolling at a negative or a positive, essentially, there.
Right, so I'll just roll. So just a straight seduction roll.
Okay, yeah, but
do the shit.
Okay, so you're trying to force a seduction on this guy just by touching him and speaking to him about his kids?
Well, you know, just general sort of like...
You know what I mean? Like, that doesn't... Like, given your current course of action and words... I mean, it's not
like I'm trying to do the weird seduction where it's like, ah, this is weird and slightly hot.
Okay. I'm going to give you a negative one because honestly, I think would not be.
I'm trying to the weird boner.
The weird boner, yeah. I mean, if you touch it enough, it might get aroused. Yeah. Okay. That's about as well as you would hope that would get. So maybe you've done the same thing. Maybe you've removed his pants as well. I don't know. Probably not.
Not yet. I work slow.
So you're looking for signs of sexual arousal, you know, like maybe...
He's got what, like a half chub?
No, not so much that, but like maybe you're used to seeing like how people's like sort of skin reacts or like, you know, maybe...
Skin flushes, eyes dilate.
Yeah, that sort of stuff, yeah. And you're not seeing any of that. So he's definitely not very receptive to your seduction attempts. However, Aina, on your side of the pond, let's get a roll here. What type of roll would you like to make here first?
Still off? Not rolling yet. I'm not even trying to interrogate this guy. I'm just setting the fucking mood.
Okay.
Much but like as I'm doing this, and again, I'm basically ignoring him at this point. Reinar is like, then I will look up. Like I was like, have you ever heard of the Native American atrocities that happened in the early 1800s? I was just reading about them. Dante says it is very important for people in our position to be well educated. And though I did not attend Cambridge Multiplex Ultraversity, is that right? Close enough.
Dante would be so proud right now.
Yeah. I think that's right. Yes. Whatever Ultraversity it was, I do have the gumption and go-getting attitude of my forebears. Anyways, the Trail of Tears, I'm going to start taking the paste with like my knife and start to smear it directly from the base of his spine over his butthole, under the perineum, and along the bottom of the shaft of his penis. Night phosphorus. There was a very notable event that happened in the history of these people called the Trail of Tears. And it was very difficult for them to deal with. People died, there was much pain and much suffering, and it was all avoidable. If they had just done what their captors had asked, then they could have gone in peace without having to be forced to die and starve and watch their children be killed in front of them. And I'm sure that this is a lesson that translates into future generations, just like ours right now. You can avoid so much hardship by just telling me, wait, hold that thought. I need to make a call. I'm going to call Dante.
All right, so Dante, in the middle of your bubble bath now, what are you doing?
I'm probably adding more. It's called Earth Tone Scents. I just like the way it smells like Ireland. It smells kind of boggy, but in a good way, not in a bad way. And I guess because I've started drinking heavily, despite the fact it's totally against my religion, I've got some scotch for no apparent reason. Dante went to Cambridge Multiplex Ultraversity. He didn't learn where alcohol comes from.
Ah, okay. They never taught that in the School of Hard Knocks, as it turns out.
True. It's true.
Yeah. So yeah, you get a phone call from Aina.
Yes. Hello. This is Dante Fierro.
Dante, it's Einar. How are things going with Astrid and the one she's trying to put her boobs on?
I have no idea.
Okay.
How are things going with you?
I want to know from these guys. I have him all ready. He is prepped to become my best friend, and we're going to tell stories about this day.
Are you going to put your boobs on him? I'm really confused right now. I thought you were going to torture him.
No. It's only torture if necessary. I don't want to have to burn off the entire lower part of his genitals. But if I have to, I will. But I need to know what we need.
I'm really concerned by you saying this because your other best friend is Ben Morta. And I don't want you burning off the lower half of his genitals without permission.
Well, it may come to the point where we have to castrate him, Dante. It's an unhappy truth, but one that we must be prepared for if the time comes.
I guess
Do you wish for him to reproduce, even by accident?
Are we talking about Ben or the person you're interrogating right now?
Ben, of course.
I don't have anything to do with how people reproduce. I mean, other people, obviously. Why would I deny him a chance at fatherhood?
A long
pregnant. Are you an ethnogenicist? That's very sad.
Can we just like get like a camera pan back and like Dante's on speakerphone and I'm just in the room like coloring a coloring book?
No,
and, like,
no,
not even not. Paying
you're
attention.
Working on the technology.
You're not in my bathroom. The pocket monster, boss.
You're not in my bathroom.
Like carefully weighing equipment from one hand to the other. Oh, this one's much heavier, yes.
Okay, put this in the heaviest section over there.
Ben needs to be constantly supervised by
an adult.
You
know, Ben's father is a very competent middle manager. Perhaps he can breed it lineagely or something, I don't know. I don't have any issue with allowing Ben to breed, or anyone else for that matter. Someone needs to replace all the victims.
It's true.
I feel like this may be a conversation we have later, but for the meantime... before I burn this man's genitals off, what do we need to know from him?
Well, I'm very curious as to his affiliation with Arasaka and Michael Knight. What he was doing there, why he was shooting at us, his target in particular. Where his super cool technology comes from. How one exactly gets turned into a head-like cyber spider. With a detachable parasol parachute. Listen, figure it out. Just torture him until he tells you things. But really concentrate on that Michael Knight thing. I'm trying to figure out if Michael's trying to kill me.
Got it. And
so remember that thing we discussed in text message, just in case.
And you're saying that Astrid hasn't yet gotten the information out of the other man yet.
I am saying that. Are you trying to imply something?
What does imply mean again, Dante?
Oh, it's just, you continue onward. I'm sure you're doing a great job.
All right, so I'll hang up the phone and turn back and be like, so sorry, it was very rude of me. However, I will burn off your genitals if you don't tell me what I want to know. The thing about this, though, is that a very dear friend of mine named Zephyr told me that burns don't kill people. It's the infections afterwards that do. I'm going to pull like a big like hypo syringe of antibiotics out of my leg satchel and be like, and I have so much penicillin here. You won't die for months.
I like the idea that there's a small cutscene, just a flashback of you at the like at the gas station, and you've got like a packet of chips, maybe like a bottle of water, a big syringe of
glasses,
thing, glasses, a war history book. Just like the guy's like, do you want a bag? And you're like, bags are bad for the environment. I'll carry.
No, I brought my own. Thank you. But it's like a little granny shopping bag.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. One of those fold away bags that's like, you know, you fold it out and it's tartan jacked.
Nah, he would carry his own stuff. Come on, he has a body of 11. He can carry that shit.
Body of 11, yeah.
So, yeah, let's swap on over to Astrid real quick. Astrid, what are you doing now that your attempt at seducing this man easily obtainable information has failed?
Good question.
Are you resorting to stabbing him slowly in different places? Like,
I'll just sort of start trying to cross-examine him a little bit. So I'll be like, so you're in this building. So I think the first thing we need to know is, who do you work for?
I mean, he's already told you. So
what was it again? No. So.
He said it once and he's not saying it again.
Okay. Oh, come on.
Oh, do you mean you personally? It was Biotechnica.
Biotechnica, okay. So, how long have you worked with Biotechnica then?
Stonewalled. He's not saying anything. He just eyes forward Staring at the dot on the wall, I guess.
Hello? Anybody there?
Yeah, nothing.
I don't have any interrogation drugs, do I?
I do.
Penicillin.
I think it may actually be time to start resorting to a small amount of torture, to be honest with you, because I don't have the good cop, bad cop thing, and I don't have the time to do the putting the two people together. Well, I don't have the time. The other guy's like, if I was going to do some interrogation, I'd do like some proper World War II, put them in a fucking room together, bug them and let them talk. Because, you know, keep them isolated for a couple of days, then you know, introduce them and let them talk about shit.
I would not do that. Like, these guys, if these guys are going to resist the kind of torture we're talking about, they're not going to slip up and talk to each other about stuff.
They might think you're bluffing.
They will eventually.
No one's done anything drastic yet.
Yeah.
aside from
what your definition of drastic is.
Yeah.
No, have you read about the during World War II, they captured a bunch of German physicists who'd been working on the German sort of like nuclear program and thing. And the way they interrogated them was basically they just stuck a whole bunch of them in a stately home, bugged the entire place, gave them, just basically treated them really well, gave them copious amounts of alcohol, and just like let rip.
Yeah, the key difference here is that they captured a bunch of civilian physicists as opposed to hardened, torture-resisting Biotechnica contract snipers.
Yeah, but this isn't torture. This is interrogation. It's not even interrogation. It's the thing is like the you catch more flies with honey thing really does work with torture, but it takes time. You can't just like. So since Astrid is on a something of a time schedule, she's just gonna sort of like. Fine then.
I have to win this competition.
And she's gonna pull her sword. Type thing out of her leg sheath and just be like, chink. Well, I guess we do this the hard way then. Are you right or left-handed?
Yeah. Nothing. Swap over to Aina. Aina, what exactly...
Throw something to him.
Guy at all perturbed by the fact that I'm smearing jellied white phosphorus on his butt and penis?
Doesn't white phosphorus kind of burn even when it's not...
No. It has to have a an ignition temperature for
that. No, I know, but it's like because phosphorus is something like, caustic, isn't it?
Yeah, like with the water in your skin or something would react and something.
No. So it's not comfortable. I'm
sure it's not comfortable.
Yeah, it's all squishy.
I think the most background. Uncomfortable part of what's happened so far is that he applied it with a combat knife.
Yeah, just like sort of screaming along. not. You know, harshly, but, you know, it's a combat knife. It's not like...
It's kind of like being someone else shaving
it's not like it's a fucking butter knife and I'm not spreading fucking grape jelly on a bagel. Confirmed.
Maybe we come back to you scraping grape jelly on a bagel to eat it.
Okay, can we finish the butt applying metaphors sometime soon?
Anyway, so yeah, what's your next step? What are you just gonna...
Is he still not saying anything at all?
Yeah, no, he's not saying anything. So, rule of thumb, just going forward, if you want something out of these guys, you either have to make a roll or do something. Okay. So, just by, you know, threatening them and smearing a goopy paste on their twig and tackle... It's not going to be enough to make them tell you what you
want. We're getting warmed up. This is fun.
I'm going to call Astrid. I'll phone a friend.
So Astrid, you flick your sword out and your phone goes off.
Oh, I'm sorry. Please excuse me. Hello?
All right. So
I was just going to sit cross-legged on the desk and just be like, just 1 second. Hello?
So... Have you gotten any interesting information out of your friend yet?
Not yet, no.
my friend and I are just getting started. See, I haven't explained to him how much worse it is to possess mangled and ruined parts of your body and to lose them entirely. Like, imagine if you had a part of your body that was crushed beyond repair in, say, a high-pressure hydraulic vise. Like, cut
hydraulic,
away.
Yeah, hydraulic vise.
High-pressure hydraulic vise in the car shop.
Uh-huh.
But then you must live with the deformity for the rest of your life, as opposed to
that's
just
true. That would ruin the rest of your life. Yes,
absolutely.
Mm.
so I'm gonna look up at the guy. Do you know who hired you to kill my friend? He's not saying anything. They're very quiet, these people.
They are. Yes, yes. I think these are going to be some tricky ones. Well, what we could probably do is maybe have a little play with both of them and then swap. I know that sort of Dante said that, you know, we had to do it all by ourselves, but really we're not going to get any useful information. I think we honestly be better combining our approaches.
Do you need him to be able to speak when I give him to you?
It would help, yes.
I'll leave his mouth open then.
Also,
does he need teeth? He doesn't need teeth to talk.
No, he doesn't need teeth. No, that's fine. Okay. Although intact genitals would be a bonus as well.
Intact genitals? But I've already applied the white phosphorus to his genitals.
White phosphorus? Ooh. I was going to put the phone down and sort of like put the phone down sort of like for a second and just be like, white phosphorus, that's really bad, right?
So maybe you just see like a little like piece of sweat drop down his like temple or something
white
like that.
White phosphorus is really bad, right? What does that do to you?
So as this is happening, like I'm going to start taking off my Metal Gear so we can see that like 2/3 of Einar's body is covered with third-degree burns. Like, just from, like, the side of the face and the neck all the way down his chest and back to, like, the top of his thighs.
I felt a little weird with you being the only naked person in the room, so.
I'm going to turn and be like,
this is weird, right? This is weird, because Astrid's fully clothed.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just
going to strip down to the waist and be like, did you know I practiced all these techniques on myself first?
My butthole is irrevocably closed.
I have to shit in a bag now.
I burned my ass shut.
All right, so I'm gonna go with the acetylene torch and spark it up.
Are you still on the phone?
Oh yeah.
So I just feel like, is that a torch?
It's an acetylene torch used for welding.
Oh, you should probably listen to this. I'm gonna hold the phone up to the guy and just be like, so this is my friend working on your friend. You might want to listen to this.
Can I roll an interrogation and do I get any bonus for anything we've done so far?
Yeah.
I'm not slapping a guy around with a fucking phone book in an alleyway somewhere.
Yeah, okay. I mean, so this role, I want to say will help with the interrogation of Astrid's person more than it will help with your person.
Do you want me to roll an intimidate or an interrogation?
Because the psychological horror is a good thing.
Yeah. So let's say that you roll an intimidate.
Oh, thank God.
And this guy that you're doing it to will do a resist torture. To see.
Sure.
But depending on the success, it'll help with your person, Astrid. So let's roll it up. Let's see what happens here.
Got a 20.
All right.
It's pretty good.
14. Okay. Why don't you give us a description of what happens when you spark this white phosphorus up?
I'm not sparking the white phosphorus up yet.
You're not? Like okay, then.
That's the end.
Then ignore my resist torture roll.
I'm still going to apply the flame to him, but not the white phosphorus part.
Okay. So where are you applying the flame?
I mean, oh, like, maybe 5 or 6 inches up his spine from where I began to smear the white phosphorus on. Like,
okay, so yeah, all right. So yeah, the resistor. So he basically, like, tries his best for, like, you hear the sound. So basically on the sound of the phone, I imagine what happens is you get the sound effects of, like, acetylene torch starting up, being sparked, and yeah, and then, like, it turning into a sharp flame, you know, when they turn the... Yeah, like that. And then it gets applied to the spine. Then you hear this like for a little bit, and then he like remembers his training, and he tries to calm down, but after a bit of time, he just starts. You just hear John, the other John Merkins, the corporal specialist, starts screaming bloody murder over the phone. Astrid, you're holding this phone up to the other interrogation target. You see him for the first time sort of look down at the phone. But then he just sort of visibly swallows and, goes back to looking at the wall in front of you, behind you.
What was your friend's name again?
Corporal John Merkins. Biotechnical Corporation.
Were you friends with John?
He's very great.
Are you friends with John? I'm sorry.
He just looks forward.
Sammy. Do you want this to happen to you? Because that's what's going to happen. Look. You could probably save your friend a lot of pain as well. If you tell us what we need to know, then I think I can help your friend.
All right, roll me something.
Can I roll interrogation?
Yes, you can. You can have a plus two for this.
Plus two. Let me find my thingy. Okay, where's interrogation gone? Where are you, interrogation? Ah, there you are. Right. Plus two.
Oh, pretty good. Yeah, not bad. So he will make a... What's the opposite of interrogation? It can't be resist torture.
Resist torture.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, alright. So he will make a roll here. Oh, yeah.
Motherfucker!
So he just, like... Maybe you see a brief moment of hesitation in his eyes. Like, especially when you mention the name John. and then he'll just sort of like, he'll steel himself and continue to look forward against the wall.
Oh, you and George close? I wonder how close you are.
So I'll take the torch away. Like, do you need his genitals intact, Astrid?
I don't know. Sammy, do we need his genitals intact?
He'll just look forward still.
The white phosphorus will leave them a part of his body, but entirely unable to function and twisted into a mass of scar tissue. It'll be quite gruesome.
A mass of scar tissue. Could I put you on speaker?
Oh, of course. It'd only be polite.
There you go. Right. Genitals, no genitals. I can't decide.
So,
oh, I tell you what.
Make a pro con list.
So the moment John hears that it's been put on speakerphone, he will shout, "Don't you fucking give him anything, Sammy! Don't you give him anything!" And that's
isn't he brave?
These guys are heroes.
Oh man, yeah, we were definitely the villains. Like, I mean, like, Astrid, if I go through with this and I burn and cauterize his anus and his perineum and his testicles and his penis all at the same time, we will be forced to implant some sort of medical shunt to allow him to urinate and defecate, or else it will back up inside of his body and he will die from septic shock.
Ooh, yes, I had a friend do that. Yes, that happened to a friend of mine. It was...
Time is of the essence in these...
It swelled up and turned yellow before that. It was horrible. Anyway,
jaundice.
Yes.
It's called jaundice.
No. Jaundice is when the liver doesn't remove toxins from the bloodstream. No, this was more urinary... It was... The urine wasn't draining, so he just swelled and it was...
He was full of shit!
Well, urine, really. Although the fecal impaction was quite unpleasant as well, yeah.
Absolutely.
But, yes. Where was I? Oh, I'm sorry, Sari. I got distracted, Sammy.
I need both hands to do what I'm going to do next, Astrid. Will you be fine with him for a while?
Do you want to just put your phone on speaker as well?
Yes, of course. Yeah. Phone activate speaker mode.
Boop. There's a little button on the
I'd imagine he just punches his phone until one of the buttons finally actually activates.
He's just a boop, 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 boop. There you go. Oh, that's loud. I'm sorry. He's not very... He's very direct, let's say. Yes. So I think we'll just sit here and listen to this for a little bit because it could be educational. But yeah, if you could try and maybe leave a little bit of the genitals intact, you know. Just maybe wash off a little of the phosphorus. Just leave the last 2 inches.
The last 2 inches are the most sensitive.
I know. Oh, I know.
Oh, God.
Okay. I'm going to turn and look at John and be like, I think you have an admirer already, John.
Okay. Let's take a break here real quick and we'll come back.
These guys are fucking hardcore. Yeah. Like, I gotta give it to them.
Yeah, man, like, in a circle, corporate soldiers, man, like, if anything, the one thing they never give up is corporate secrets. So, you know, good luck with that.
Set Span Mortal loose on him.
You know,
oh, God, that was terrifying. Like,
oh, yeah. Come on, do tell. I'm super curious.
You should bring Band in, and he's so fucking inept. They're like, oh my God, what can he do?
I like the idea that Ben comes in. He's like, you know, I once beat up a sex doll.
This guy's fucking so
take a break from all the this weird stuff that's happened in the first portion and head on over to the resident happy-go-lucky man, Mr. Band Mortar. So, Band, you've got a shitload of gear in front of you, including a gyro sniper rifle, which is essentially a little mini rocket launcher, essentially. What are you doing? What are you doing? Tell me what you're doing.
Well, I'm probably just like organizing these things for Dante.
Mm-hmm.
So I spend a while doing that. First, I do it by barrel size, but then I decide length of gun is better.
It's not that many guns. It's mostly like there's a lot of let's see what do these guys have on them. So they would have, there'd be two handguns, a submachine gun, and the Remington gyro sniper rifle.
Okay.
The SMG is called the Sternmeyer SMG 21, and the pistols are the Sternmeyer Type 35s. In terms of gear, they mostly just had like flak armor, so it's nothing you guys haven't seen before. They had a hand grenade each. What else do they have here? Yeah, that's about it. Oh. Yeah, that's pretty much it, yeah. So, you know, aside from like, you know, that'd have
okay,
like
I know what I'm
radio
I know what
and
I'm
stuff like
do.
That. Yeah.
It's like just a few things. I'm just gonna kinda set them up around me and get like a super gangster selfie. No.
Put it on Facebook? Yeah.
No. Yeah, I just text the stuff to Dante, let him know what we got. and ask if he's got, you know, duties, instructions.
Is there something in particular you'd like to work on?
Let's see. Yeah, I'd write back and just be like, well, when they,
no, I'm calling you. I'm literally calling. You call.
Okay.
Even though we're probably like two rooms apart and I could just yell, I'm calling because I'm still in the bathtub.
We'll could do some more drawings. I mean, I really want to work on the game, boss. Like,
okay, progress. Do that. Very good. Nice work.
And I hang up with the boss. And I'm actually going to write a letter to my parents before I get to work on the drawings.
Dear Mom and Dad.
Dear Mom, indeed.
I'm feeling like a man these days, so just wanted to let you know. You know, what are you writing about?
Yeah, I'm writing like, dear Mom, indeed. Things are going great here at the company. So glad to be on board. Dante's treating me amazing. He's as good a boss as one could ask for. I've even made a couple friends here at the workplace. Although one of them did get shot in the back by the other one's father. But still, I've got one very close friend, and the boss Dante isn't too unfriendly, so that's good. Anyways, got my first paycheck, and that was fun. Got to buy some new gear for my computers. Hope to see you soon. Maybe Thanksgiving. Love you, boy.
Fire off an email. Goes off to the parents.
Yeah. And then I'm going to get down and dirty about some fucking pocket monsters.
Sweet. Give me a drawing check.
Yes!
Oh my god, that's the best pocket monster.
Alright, so what is the pocket monster that goes on the cover art here?
Okay, yeah. let's see, what do we want for the fucking...
It'd be some cute fucking thing, yeah? I'd imagine. That they use in the anime? Like, to death?
Oh, it's probably like a robo pocket monster with like lasers and maybe it looks a little bit like Einar. but it's like even mechier.
So it's like
a chibi mech.
A chibi mech. Okay, sure. And that's on the front of the box art.
And it's like blasting one of the other pocket monsters.
I like it. Great. All right. So let's swap back to the action unfolding. And for some reason, for no reason at all, I'm going to roll a 1d100.
Which one of these men is wired with an explosive?
They both are. Just kidding. No, you're both dead. It's now the band and Dante show.
They've got cranial explosives. Yay!
All what right. are we going to do tonight, Dante?
The same thing we do every night. Watch soap opera reruns.
Our homeless people under the roof with tacos and then throw them off. At some point, they'll learn.
There's some pretty fucking good tacos, though.
I hear there's a really good...
Darwinism in action.
I hear there's a really good office space that gives out free tacos to the homeless.
And then it rains dead guys afterwards. It's crazy, man.
Put a fucking
pair of shoes and you can get some tacos.
Yeah, well, the taco vendor's just there with a big fucking vat just basically saying tacos.
Slurping that guy out. Yeah, I would literally just buy that guy out and then hire him on as a chef at his own company. Perfect. Nailed it.
He can do
that. That way I can get the tacos basically. For free.
I mean, if we just have his taco truck on the roof, people will come up there to buy tacos, then we could throw them off.
I mean, that's like a GTA-style thing where put a taco truck on a roof, just random civilians will spawn there and come and get some.
Took you like 30 minutes, but it's worth it.
You gotta pick it up with a fucking helicopter and just do.
Yeah, of course. Yep.
Crashed into a couple of buildings.
Make it do a barrel roll.
So, Aina, let's start with you. Where were we at?
Man, I feel like at this point, Einar has tried his best to be hospitable to this guy and try to convince him.
Look, I'm trying to be nice to you right now.
You know, in his best interest, in the interest of any future children he may want to have,
sure,
to tell him what he wants to know, even though he hasn't actually asked him any questions yet.
Okay.
Like, Einar just expects him to know what Einar wants to know and tell him.
Okay. And
apparently,
yeah.
So before, like, you know, I've been torturing him with the acetylene torch, like, this is your last chance. If you tell me who ordered the hit on my friend, I will not irrevocably mutilate and scar your genitalia and your means of expelling waste from your body.
Did you say that to his face?
Yes.
It sounds like he does.
All right, give me a human perception check, please.
A human perception check.
Yes, this is like body language and changes.
Damn.
Okay, so maybe you're looking at him for any sign of anything. Mm-hmm. And he looks down at you for the briefest of moments. And then, like, just a little tiny, the smallest, faintest little glow of green. Boop. Hits his, like, just glows in both eyes at the same time.
Hmm.
And then he just looks back up at the wall.
Would I have any way of understanding what this is?
Do you have on you, sir? Any sort of cyber enhancement skills? Like, I would accept electronics. I would accept cyber. No. Do you have cybertech, the technical skill?
I have demolitions.
No, you have no idea what that was.
All right.
But you noticed.
I mean, just based off what I imagine it is, it's either an explosive or like.
I've just shut off all my fucking nerves.
Highly likely that it's demons, guys.
There's no wireless internet, or else I'd say it was probably like a camera and he's transmitting his voice to him. There's no wireless internet.
So.
Hmm. I'm going to take out about, I don't know, 4 grams of cocaine from the 1 kilogram we all kept for our personal use, and I am going to just, like, pry his mouth open and shove all 4 grams into his mouth.
Damn, son!
Can I get a strength save from you?
I don't know a lot about drug use. Is that a lot?
He just upped the cinnamon challenge. I'll tell you that.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Did you give me some sort of comparative here?
Yeah, like the cinnamon challenge on, like, a heaping tablespoon.
A heaping tablespoon of cocaine.
Okay, yeah.
I mean,
Okay. But you take cocaine in little tiny lines, generally. So.
I mean, yeah. You must not have seen the same television shows that
basically,
I watched.
A fingernail, like, yeah, no. In real world terms, like a fingernail, a little, you take a little pinch on your little finger, and that's about the normal,
okay.
You know.
All right.
Recreational dose.
Die from that much cocaine.
Possibly.
Okay.
Really? Yeah.
You're probably not on my watch, because many drugs.
He's going to cough some of that out, I think.
Yeah.
Can I get a strength feat from you to try?
If you're putting it straight in his mouth, it's not going to be as effective.
Give me a strength feat to see if you can open this guy's
jaw. Imagine he'll inhale a lot of it right after that, though.
You know how you, like, go to bite into a donut that has powdered sugar on it? You go, and then
you get all the powder in your lungs
because
you want to cough? Yeah, that's good.
Okay. Yeah, no, you easily do that. Can you give me... he's just going to... The DC here is going to be 15. Oh, yeah. No. You push it into his mouth and you, like, massage his neck or whatever, but he doesn't do anything. He doesn't swallow.
I mean, it's fine. It's absorbed through the mucous membrane.
Yeah, it's like... He doesn't need to swallow it. It's like...
And now his whole face is numb, though. You won't be able to torture him there.
Yeah. From what I hear, anyway, I've obviously never... No, anyway.
Yep. So, yeah, this guy just, I don't know. You're not getting the reaction you want out of him essentially.
Am I getting any of the... I mean, like, Einar is incredibly frustrated. Mm. Like, nothing he's doing is working. He doesn't want to really scar and mutilate
this. I know.
He just got so angry that he's trying to choke him to death with cocaine. He's really angry.
I was going to be like, Einar, what was that choking noise?
I gave him about a half an Einar dose of cocaine.
Ah, interesting. What's the reaction?
He's twitching. There's some foam coming from both his nose and his mouth. One of his ears is bleeding rather profusely, and he can't focus. Like I'm, you remember, like snapping my fingers in front of his
face. I wouldn't say all that, but he's certainly really dosed.
Emphasizing for the other guy that can hear.
So. Yeah. Do you have adrenaline on hand? Just in case.
Of course.
Okay, good. We wouldn't want to kill these gentlemen, would we?
Yeah, like, I imagine you guys, like, at the gas station, you're like, oh, and one of those behind it, and he turns around and is like, cigarettes? Like, no, the adrenaline shot, and he grabs that.
Yeah. Are these, what's the sell-by date on these? These are out of date. Do you have any in the back?
Yeah. I like things to be a mystery. But yeah, so I'm just going to sit out and like pick up the book, like wipe off some of the blood on it, and get back to reading it.
Mm. So, Einar, did we not do anything interesting recently?
Well, I liked getting to know each other while we were chasing these guys down. They were fairly skilled. I have much respect for their ability and their loyalty to Biotechnica, and whatever person hired them to kill whichever one of our friends, they were hired to kill.
Yeah, I mean, it's really, you can't hold a grudge. They're just doing the job.
Absolutely. It is a very professional thing. I would hope...
I mean, really, we're all in the same similar line of work, so, you know.
Sure. If I was ever caught doing something like this, I would hope to comport myself with the same dignity and stoicism that these men are.
Indeed, I'm quite impressed.
But I also have lost feeling to the majority of my body, so... Perhaps they have as well. You know who would know more about this kind of thing? We had a friend once, a man who was very skilled in surgery and cyberware named Mirage. We can always call him and see what he thinks.
That is a genius idea. Yes.
What if Mirage could heighten their sensitivity to pain and shut off the overload?
I'm going to be staring directly into the guy's eyes at this point while I'm listening to this and be like,
go on.
Because at some point the body loses its ability to transmit the pain signal.
Yeah.
But I'm sure Barash could sidetrack that somehow, circumvent it, so you would feel everything always, forever, the rest of your life.
Oh, like chronic pain syndrome, but in, you know, artificially induced. Right,
actually, yes. Real and founded in science.
Ah.
Would this also work to turn non-ticklish people ticklish?
We can only fucking hope, the bastard.
Right. I'm afraid that I will have to tell Dante that this man was able to resist everything up to the point where I had to burn his genitals irrevocably.
Did you try to burn the genitals off yet?
Not yet. You'd asked me not to.
No, I said just leave the last couple of inches.
Okay. I'm going to go wipe off, you know. Get like a little moisturized.
That's not going to work.
I imagine you also ate some KFC on the way and you have one of those moist towelettes.
Yeah, it's a moist towelette.
just wrap it in a moist towelette. That'll protect it.
Yeah. Then what?
And like, I suppose that I'm left with no choice.
Okay, let me just... Two seconds. Okay, so you have a choice to save your friend's, you know, special area.
John is such a strapping lad, too. He has so many years ahead of him of happiness and joy, sharing it with whomever he decides to do so until I do this. And then his life will be misery and torture for a very, very short period of time before he dies from septic shock from being unable to evacuate his bowels.
Indeed. And Sammy, this is up to you, Sammy. This is your decision.
Astrid, can you give me a human perception check, please?
Uh-huh. Where are we? Ha-boop.
Okay, yeah. You're looking at Sam,
And he just looks back at you. His face unwavering.
He's like, did you say Barash? The legend.
No, but like, so, Sammy, you...
Mafia guy.
You, John, I just want you to be aware that Sammy is not helping you. That's kind of sad, really.
So maybe, okay, maybe Sammy, for this the is... first time, I and I, you see like just a slight smirk on John's face at the at hearing that. So,
oh dear. Well, oh, go ahead then.
I'm gonna light him up.
All right, do you light him up?
Yep. I'm gonna very That's carefully important. Watch Sammy's face while this happens.
All right, so the following events happen. You light up the trail of death and destruction from Taint.
The unhappy trail.
The unhappy trail.
Oh, that's the best description of it so far.
Yeah. And it does everything that the chemical reaction is supposed to do. Like, it sears flesh, it burns the skin. But John doesn't make a sound. Not one. His face doesn't change. For you, the smell is a mixture of chemical and
familiar. It's very familiar.
Burning.
Einar has been burned over 2/3 of his body.
Yeah. It's the last thing he ever smelled.
And maybe we can get like a flashback from you or something like that as to how you got these burns. Because maybe this brings back memories for you.
Einar got hit by a Molotov cocktail. Like, direct hit. When he was fighting as a child soldier in the Netherlands.
And did you scream in pain when this happened?
Yeah, I mean, he was like 11. So yeah. Yes.
So when this man in front of you literally just mad dogs you while this is happening with literally no emotional change or resonance whatsoever, it kind of gets to you a little bit. Give me a cool check, actually.
Sure.
This will be just a 15 or whatever, so.
Oh. Have I ever mentioned how much I love this system?
Yeah.
So I don't have roll 20 right now. I have the zoom up on top of it, but I don't have to look. I don't have to look.
So he rolled a 1. Can you roll me a d10 for me, please? Sure. An 8, that's pretty bad. Alright, books. Data Fortress, there we go. Alright. Doot, fumble. Cool. Oh, there's no fumble for cool, so.
Aha!
But,
just act kind of lame.
Yeah, no, this sort of gets to you, though. Like, it's sort of like, this man should be in pain. This man should be screaming like you screamed when your skin burned to flesh.
Oh, yeah.
And for you, it's kind of unnerving. Like, what is Biotechnica doing to their soldiers to make them
It's confusing. Like, I mean, like, look down at the torch, look back at him. The blisters spreading and the blood seeping down his legs, like everything that happens with a horrific burn wound. And he's just sitting there. And I think you're right. He's both very uneasy and very confused by what's happening.
Yeah. And the same thing can be said for you, Astrid. Like, you hear the sound effects of the chemical reaction happening and you hear like,
it's like,
because it does sound like crackling or whatever, but screams. Like no screams are happening. And then maybe Sammy on your side is also just looking at you like deadpan. No emotion whatsoever in his face.
I'm going to just sort of pick up my knife, just sort of... And just sort of like slowly stab him in the hand.
He just looks.
Is there any reaction at all?
None whatsoever. He looks directly at you.
Ah. Interesting.
He doesn't even like he doesn't even register that you've put the knife into his hand. Like, nothing.
To be fair, that's what happens with Ban, too. But that's just, like...
I'd be like, there's no screaming. I know.
No screaming whatsoever. This is very confusing. I'm going to try to shoot him a few times.
No, wait.
Astrid, it's how I solve my problems when I get confused.
I know, but Ina, please allow me to offer another solution.
I'm not going to suck his dick.
Oh, no. That's fine. I do the dick sucking around here. No. Obviously, just physical torture won't work on them. I think we need to go tinkering around in their brains.
Barash is excellent at that.
Yes. I think perhaps Barash would... Yes. I think we should do that. We probably need them fairly intact, so you should probably put the other guy out. What was his name again? John?
His name was John Merkins. I don't know what his name is now. All that identified him as who he was, his genitalia, his anus, are gone.
His name now is John Hurton.
John Hurtons?
John, I need a Merkin.
So even if he doesn't feel pain, in a little bit it's going to be uncomfortable for sure.
Pain? You don't know.
It's gonna like pop if he eats anything.
Yes, it's time to have a tinker around in your little brain, then, isn't it? Okay, Sammy, I'll be like, so if you want to bring this one back here and we can,
why would we bring the horribly burned man back to the place? Shouldn't you bring him here? And Dante and Band and whomever else wants to be a part of this little get together.
Okay, I suppose. Yes, I'll talk to you later. Okay, bye. I'll just phone Dante because it's like.
Dante, what are you doing right now?
Well, no one's told me that they have an incredibly terrible plan to go to Barash.
That's what I'm about to tell you.
So,
hello, it's me, Barash. I hack into your phone call.
No. I'm getting out of the tub and I'm putting on like like kafia, like midday sun Palestinian garb of a rich prince. I normally wear American clothes, but I'm feeling very tortury today.
All right.
Okay, so I'm just on, you know, your phone's going right now, so.
Oh, I answer my phone. Hello, this is Dante Fierro.
Hello, Mr. Fierro. We've had a bit of a roadblock with the torture.
You know, that's not what I want to hear, right?
I know it's not what you want to hear, but unfortunately...
I'm like adjusting straps.
Yes. Unfortunately, like... these are the facts right now. I hope I'm not interrupting you, by the way.
You know, I'm just doing my hair right now.
Oh, I'm sorry. I know how fiddly that can be. Yes, so we've...
Don't you just take the hair from your victims or something?
Not quite.
Okay. But, you know, now the more that I think about it, the less that I want to get out of the bathroom, and the more I want to have a nice hot shower again. So, yeah, let's talk about something other than the fact that you wear dead people.
It's true.
Certainly. We've hit a certain roadblock in as much as we don't believe these people can actually feel pain. And they seem remarkably resistant to torture. So we were
going to get things.
Yes, but we were going to get Barash to tinker around in their brains.
No. I need Barash exactly where he is, developing weapons of war for me. Listen. Teletubbies, Led Zeppelin, just get all of the worst songs ever created. And just play them on a continual loop. You know, I was thinking Dixie Chicks, maybe.
Dixie Chicks
is banned.
Teletubbies doing Led Zeppelin 2 is amazing, boss. Don't rip on that.
You're a monster!
Teletubbies was banned.
I'm waiting for the chat outrage.
Tinky Winky, Dixie, La La, Purr. No, see, I have a child. So I've suffered Teletubbies, and I'm right. Seriously getting...
Well, I don't think I've seen more than, like, advertisements for their stuff.
So we've established that they can hear and answer questions. Now I need you to torture them with audio torture.
I just... I really doubt that will work.
All right.
I think we need to go deeper.
No. We're going to do the audio torture thing. The third thing we're also going to do is you're going to set up cameras in your room and you're going to show your current person how you are torturing the other person. And maybe they'll be like, no, I really don't want my genitals being burned off like that guy. That seems bad. I might not be able to feel pain myself, but I can feel empathy for other people.
I'm not sure if they can, sir.
You think they can't have emotions?
They seem pretty blank right now, sir.
Let me call Ina.
Certainly, sir.
Oh, you got it. Hello, this is Ina.
Ina.
Hello, this is Einar.
I'm curious, Einar.
I thought you were Dante. I am very confused, even more than I just was.
Einar, listen, this is Dante Fierro. I was just trying to...
Oh, Dante, hello.
Greeting. I'm very concerned. I feel like people on the internet are saying I have no taste in music, so fuck themselves. That's an aside. Let's get back to the important things to talk about.
Is it that woman again? The one that you asked me to kill?
What? You're going to have to be way more specific than that. I feel like over the last few weeks, we've killed a lot of women.
The harridan you call your wife.
No. It's people on the internet. You wouldn't understand. It's a Ben Morta thing.
It's terrible drawings of small creatures with large noses?
I agree. That is what they tend to do. That's what they put in their profile pictures. It's ridiculous. You think they could get some class? All right, listen. This is what's going to happen. It sounds like these people can't feel pain. Is that correct?
I have burned his genitals and his anus closed.
That's terrifying. I didn't need to know that. And I prefer to kill the people that I'm going to kill. Here is the new torture. You're going to play continual audio streams of the worst songs in history.
Can I just stream them a live chat with Band Morta?
No.
Over and over again on loop?
I'm not a monster.
What if Band Morta is also listening to Nickelback at the time?
Not like you to say sorry.
And he's singing along, no, too.
I draw a line at Hanson, okay?
Oh, God, Hanson.
You are also going to set up, I don't know, some sort of camera setup with Astrid, where you show the prisoners what you are doing to the other prisoner so that they feel empathy about losing their junk and stuff and watching their buddy get horribly tortured.
If only you had a meteor.
They might not be able to feel pain, but they can feel empathy, right? That, I mean, they are capable of both hearing and feeling emotions.
I do not know if I could presume that they can feel... I am confused again.
I should be going to for emotional advice. That's true.
I'm confused again. Feeling for other people...
Like you felt for Zephyr.
That was only the one night, Dante.
Right, but for one night you felt something for someone else, correct?
It was...
Don't you feel admiration for me and want my pride?
Of course.
Perhaps one of these men wants to not see his friend be horribly tortured. It's strange, I know. I'm literally rolling my eyes right now. I'm a sociopath, and I still don't get why he doesn't understand this.
I have trusted your guidance so far, and I will continue to trust it in this matter.
All right, work it out. We're still taking recommendations for the most terrible music ever. But really, anything that involves Japanese kabuki theater, I think, is going to go in there as well.
That'll do it. All right. So what's the plan here? You just want to try
the Wiggles.
If Chip was here, he has composition. He could write specifically bad music.
The fucking Wiggles.
To torture them with.
Wake up, Jeff. Everybody's waiting. Wake up.
He literally just makes Kanye West. Boom. Fucking nailed it. Actually, I'm a fan of Kanye, so get wrecked.
Yeah.
So what kind is earlier? Do you just want to like assault these guys with music and stuff? Like, I'm a little confused as to how you plan on doing that.
He wants to assault them with music and blind them with science, Dave.
I mean, if this is based off of like actual military interrogation techniques, they're going to use a varying array of audio frequencies that are chaotic and constantly changing in order to.
Ooh, I could write a torture program that runs off my computer to make like shitty tones.
Yeah, it's just like destabilize them, like don't give them time to like calm down.
It's to stress their sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous systems. Hmm. And to prevent them from being able to recover by becoming used to a specific cadence or rhythm of auditory input.
Okay, sure. How?
It's like being in a really loud, annoying party.
Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have like a random oscillation between square waves, sine waves, sawtooth waves, and triangle waves.
That's fine. What I'm saying is to get all this set up, to get the video feed set up, like you got to remember video is like the hardest thing to do in this world.
Right away when they come, I'm like, I don't think the video is necessary. Large plexiglass that we put in between them. Drill holes for sound. I mean, it's very critical. We could put that down in the warehouse there.
Okay.
Like, no need to go high tech.
Yeah.
Talking to Dante probably about the plan then.
I'm still just sort of like offering the guy coffee and just being like,
we're in a transitional phase.
Yeah.
We wait for the next set of torture.
Yeah, but you know, like, would you like a cup of coffee while you wait? Yes. Okay, we're sorry to, you know, we apologize for the delay.
Before you do the audio torture, you play elevator music for him.
Yeah, you clear their palate.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd be like, so we've got a survey. So how would you feel your torture has gone today from 1 to 10, you know, sort of like
I'm feeling like a 5, you know.
It's like
straight down the middle, you know, like anyway.
Yeah.
So give me some actionable stuff here, guys. What do you want
to
do?
Okay. So yeah, I set up like the computer program to like basically a small synthesizer.
I mean, yeah, I don't want to interrupt you, Virgil, but before we go too deep into this, I'm aware that you guys failed your attempts to torture them, and I was offering advice based on what my character would say. If this isn't going to work, we can just skip to the part.
Oh, I'm going to torture it.
Okay.
Yeah. We all get a turn.
Dan Zorda coming in off the bench.
Yeah.
Dan comes in with pinch torture. Heads and a 9 and just
fucking destroys
it. Born to torture.
All right, so give me an idea of what you're doing.
So much practice.
Yeah, do you know what the Shepherd Rising tone is? It's crazy. If you haven't heard it, you should listen to it. I've got like that going on. All kinds.
Is that with a H or
Shepherd Rising tone? S H
Rex
or S H
S H E P E or S H E P H E R?
No H. I think it's an
right.
A though. Wait, where was it? If you just say rising tone, I think it'll come up.
Okay. So, yep, you got some audio mumbo jumbo going on.
What is with a H? I think.
So, am I just going to just straight up do a torture roll then? Or are we going to do any pre rolls?
So, what's your setup here? Are you going to which place? I'm assuming you're going to go to the one that's in the house that you're in.
Oh, I wanted them to set up the warehouse for me.
Okay.
But if we can set up somewhere else, that's fine.
Okay, so explain to me what you want. You want two dudes on the other side of plexiglass?
Yes. And, I mean, these guys can do whatever tortures they want, but my whole thing is I have some pretty big speakers in there from the stereo system. They've got plastic sheeting on them, Dante, to protect them from blood. And I equip my friends with some earplugs.
So surely you use big ass ear defenders.
And then headphones on top of those, maybe. And then I start playing my terrible, god awful sounds to them.
Okay.
Where is the
So torture? It's going to cost a bit of money to set this up and a bit of time.
Okay. I mean, I got the money. I can buy the stereo equipment and stuff if I need to.
Sure. Now, let's see here. How long will this guy last bleeding from every orifice that he has without any sort of medical...
He's not every orifice, he's just every lower orifice.
He's not actually bleeding. Like,
yeah, the wounds are cauterized.
I mean, he's going to become infected very quickly, but yeah, that'll be a matter of hours.
He's probably seeping and oozing a bit.
It would take a bit of time to build a room to torture these people in with a plexiglass thing in the middle, like Band wants, and then fill it full of sound.
So it would be hours for the infection to accumulate enough to actually begin to affect him physiologically. And it would probably take him 3 to 4 days to actually die from the infection.
Okay, that's fair. I would say it would...
As long as we should keep him hydrated, though.
So, yeah, are you guys going to be monitoring these people at all times? Because, like, if you rush this build, they're not going to be very secure. And, like, I'm really don't understand why you guys are, like, making such an elaborate thing here.
It's not that elaborate. I mean, they wanted... The boss specifically asked for them to be able to see each other. So okay. That's why I did that.
Yeah.
I want to torture them with sound, so that's why I bought some sick-ass tweeters. And hook them up.
That's fine. We can
toss one of these guys into the office and just fucking chain him up. There's already a window, and he can look out onto the main floor where we have the other guy trussed up.
Okay, that's fine. You can do that.
Shouldn't be that big of a deal.
And he's probably just like holding his ears and screaming.
Now, okay, remember, so this place is completely fucked up. Like, it's not an office anymore. It's like a hole in a wall.
I thought we got that repaired.
No, nothing was repaired in this place.
Okay, so I assume since these guys couldn't feel pain, I'm not going to get any kind of bonus.
No.
From the previous torture.
Nope.
Okay.
Ooh.
That's a really good roll. That was a 9.
Interrogation is specifically you talking to them.
Oh, I need to do torture then?
Yeah, so that would be like intimidate or whatever. So,
Where is it?
I mean,
is it any different?
You want to just keep the exact same roll?
Yeah, is it any different? Is your points different? What's the point difference there?
I think it's just most of everything I have is level 1. Where's torture? Resist torture.
No, intimidate is underneath.
It's not a cool.
Intimidate is cool, so. Wait, there's a torture roll?
Isn't there a torture
roll? No, it's intimidate, so.
Yeah, they're the same thing.
Yeah, so are they the same?
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. We can keep that roll then. So yeah, I guess, like, after a couple hours of, actually, let me just check to make sure that they don't have anything in here.
Isn't there?
Oh. That's fucking interesting. That's actually really interesting. Okay, so the amount of time that you guys get set up and you do all this stuff. Aina, can you give me... Do you have any sort of medical at all? And the reason I'm asking you to do this is because you would have experience with this. But do you have...
I have a first aid of 1 and a pharmaceuticals of 1.
Give me a first aid. And this would be a very easy check, like a 10.
Okay. Perfect.
Perfect. Nice. Okay, so yeah. The John fella actually seems a lot healthier than you would imagine him to be at this point. But yeah, let's see, so I'm going to roll 2 resist torches. Wow. Okay. I'm going to say that this would probably be,
the one you cooked up.
Yeah. Well, maybe not him, but I would probably say
Sammy.
It's probably Sammy. Yeah.
Sammy Sosa.
Let's see. 2 would probably just be nothing. But I want to check. You can't get it together. Yeah. So, yeah, the Sammy reacts in a very strange way. Look at that. John is stoic as fuck, though.
He's like, I listen.
You can take my balls, but you'll never take my freedom.
Like, so, I listen to techno metal.
Yeah.
Fucking awesome.
So maybe Sammy reacts to seeing John more than to the music.
Oh my god, what have we done to him?
Yeah. Yeah, so he doesn't break down or anything, but he's definitely angry now. And that's more than you've been able to get out of him up until this point. Gotcha. So, Mr. Van Water, what's your next step?
Well, so we got one of them broken, right?
Yeah.
Not broken, just pissy.
Reacting.
Okay.
He's no longer maintaining a stoic separation.
Yeah, he's not cool, calm, and collected anymore. Like, you could probably interrogate him now if you wanted to.
Okay. Yes, I will go ahead and do that. And I'm trying to, like, be tough, but it's not, you know, that tough.
Okay.
I almost pull out my gun, and then I remember it's only half a gun.
You do that thing where you put it in your, like, your jacket pocket, and you point it at a guy?
yeah, it's like, this is really a gun. I swear to God. Yeah, and I'm like, look, things are going to get worse from here. You better start speaking up, bro. Who sent ya? Who you after? We need to know what you're doing if you're going to get out of here. Okay, mate? Now just relax and tell us everything you know.
All right.
I'm going to be behind him sort of like gently massaging his shoulders while he's doing this. Just like...
10. Natural 10. 21 is the
You're
total.
The good cop, I guess, in this situation. All right. Before that happens, though, I need everyone who's in the room human perception.
Okay. Fuck yes! Another natural 10!
Where the fuck's my human perception gone?
It's in the empathy.
Where the fuck is empathy gone? Oh, there. Right.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God.
Everyone who got crits, just put some 2 IP, floating IP next to those skills. Everyone, you definitely notice, like, John, like, he blinks twice and nods at Sammy. And, you don't know what that means, but he definitely communicates with him okay. Now that they're within eyesight of each other.
I have a bad feeling about this.
The interrogation, what did you actually ask him?
I asked him who sent them, who they were after, and what else does he know?
So Sammy looks up at you and he goes, Biotechnica sent us. We had our contract.
Who's the mark then? Who is it?
A man by the name of Weston Highland.
Oh, okay. He was Weston. I was trying to get Weston.
Interesting. I'm gonna sort of pull Einar aside out of the earshot of these guys and just go, did you see the wink? I have a bad feeling about this.
I don't.
I'm over there asking stupid questions.
Length of submission.
I just be very, very alert and ready to act just in case. Bad feeling. Yeah. I'm going to keep my knife unlimbered, just sort of casually.
Yeah. And this is Sammy, right?
Yeah, this is Sammy.
Yeah. I'm like, well, it's like this, Sammy. I barely know the fella. You just joined up, see? So probably don't even know what you're on about. He used to be with the gangs, right? You a gang member? With Biotechnica? It's just a... one-off job, then.
If you don't want to be on the receiving end of what we have to offer,
I suggest you stop interrogating. If you know too much, that would be a problem for you.
Well, if I don't find out the information, Dante will kill me.
He just sort of... Dante Fierro.
Oh, yeah. He's, like, really good boss, only super strict. If you mess up, he'll kill you.
Dante Fierro of Monte Santa Jojo Corporation.
Oh, yeah, see? He's actually, you know, pretty good mate of mine, I'd say. Don't ask him. He won't agree. But,
I'm going to take my knife, sort of like standing behind this Sammy, and then just like fucking shove it through his spinal column, because I have a very, very bad feeling about this, and I think we need to stop this right now.
So you do that. Again, he just looks straight at Band, and he's just like... His face doesn't change at all.
What, when I've severed his fucking spine?
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot what I was saying. That's so distracting.
Is he still alive?
Yeah. Give me a,
Wait!
Give me a attack, please. We'll see how much damage you do to him.
Isn't he then helpless captive?
Yeah.
Where the fuck is attack again?
It's more like how well she can sever the spine more than.
Gotcha.
Alright, what do I roll for attack? Because
just you should have melee under weapons. You should have like, a short sword. Ooh. Yeah.
Ah.
There you go. Just hit that for me, please. Just the first circle.
Wait, what?
The gray circle next to short sword.
Just hit that. Right, okay.
And you can have a +5 for him.
Being you attempted like, to use a roll command looking for the value of a selected token, but no tokens. I need to click on my.
Just click on one of the gray one of the guys there.
Okay. And a +2, right?
Yeah, +5.
Oh, +5. Okay.
I mean, he's bound and restrained, so.
AP no. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. So this is if you got under a 10, it would have been that your aim was off and you basically
cut your finger.
No. You would have instead of inserting into the spinal column, you would have like pushed around the side of it, sort of thing, right?
Oh, I'm sorry, I got blood everywhere. Ooh, so messy.
Okay, so I collect my thoughts and I'm like,
is it the whole Biotechnica broken up building where it got formed out and then he was there and then he left and
so all that information.
I'm gonna shove a knife through his eye socket then since obviously suffering spinal.
Hang on. Sorry. Don't get ahead of yourself. So basically as Band you're saying that stuff, you see him like his body react to having something go into his spine. But then you just see the life sort of like fade from his eyes, basically. But he has no facial reaction whatsoever when he does that. So, basically, like his eyes stay open and he just sort of like slumps down in the chair slowly. The only thing that's keeping him up now is the restraints.
Okay, I feel for her pulse.
Okay, right.
No, he's dead. He's super dead. Yeah, he's dead.
He's dead, mate.
Yes, he is.
Oh, he was like jillying my hands.
He was interrogating you.
Oh no, but he's going to be dead in like minutes. I mean, he's dead now.
I'm going to take the knife and just like stalk towards the other guys and be like, no. And sort of like sever his spine as well.
Jeez, okay. Yeah, we don't need to roll for this one. There's no need to do it. Like, however... So basically what happens is, when you sever this guy's spine, his wounds, his lower body wounds, it like, I guess sort of reverts would be the right word. And you know, you've seen this, you know exactly what this is. Like you look at it and you're like, oh, nanomachines. Okay.
Mm.
He had nanomachines within his body that was healing his wounds, essentially.
Mm. These men were extraordinarily dangerous, and they knew who Dante was.
Well, Dante is a very famous and important man.
No, because we told him.
Well, I've probably seen his dick pics. I mean, it's...
DanteFiero.info is a very, very populated site upon
the internet. Band just told them there was a link.
Look, he was on the roof.
Driving a car.
The link was Dante showing up outside the building we chased.
Yes, I know, but they, you know, sort of like he just confirmed that link to them.
I'm not disagreeing, but they had plenty of opportunity to connect me when I was shooting them or driving a car.
Look, if Dante's not going to kill me over it, it's fine.
But yeah, I'm just like, I had a very bad feeling.
Fans mistake to me, for sure.
I was like, I apologize, but I had a very bad feeling, and I acted on it.
Well, it's all good. I mean,
these men were a risk.
At least we know they're the Westin, and they're from Biotechnica, so it's probably about the information that he got about the processing.
Yes, but I don't think they had anything further for us, and quite frankly, considering this man's wounds were healing very quickly due to nanomachines, they were heavily probably augmented with nanomachines and God knows what else.
Oh, but I reckon they was just mercenaries, eh? What do you think, Anna?
They were contractors. Oh, buddy? Mercenaries are a little bit different than contractors, but they were very tough. A mercenary works for anyone. A contractor tends to work for a specific corporation or government entity. And they also very likely belong to the Guild of Snipers.
Oh.
The most honorable Guild of Snipers. Established.
Yeah, so they were Biotechnica mercenaries looking for... Yeah.
The elite division, obviously.
1968, after the Vietnam War.
But yeah, so we have the information we need. These men are no longer a risk, although we should, well, take samples. Because these nanomachines are quite useful, so worth studying. And yes, take samples and then burn the bodies. We don't want to leave any evidence, after all.
Why don't we want to leave evidence?
Never be traced.
But how will your enemies know to fear you if you do not let them see the...
Is it not more terrifying if everybody you send against someone just quietly disappears?
But I think it depends upon...
Well, look, we're dealing with these folk over there with the Westin.
Oh, we don't have to worry then. They're just after Westin.
I think that's the point. I mean, it's not really an issue.
Still, I think burning the bodies would be more hygienic. Don't leave any loose ends.
Well, there's like a firing barrel over there.
Indeed. I'll sort of... Do you have any syringes left?
Of what?
Just empty ones.
He opens his jacket. They're just full of syringes.
Yeah. Do you have any clean empties? Yeah, do you have any clean empties?
No. Why would you want a syringe that is empty? It doesn't make any sense.
To fill it.
What's inside the syringes that is good?
Oh, never mind. I think I have a sample jar. There we go. Right, I'll just sort of like open a vein and get some samples of blood and whatever.
Oh, just finished me hot tamales. You could put it in the package there.
It's fine. Thank you. I think that's for a colouring book over there. Why don't you just...
just meander off looking for the colouring book.
Like, I didn't see it last time I was here. Can't believe I missed it.
Oh, we'll have to look harder then. Right, if you could... Einar, could you help me get these guys into the barrel? Do you have any of the phosphorus left?
Of course. I have many white phosphorus grenades.
Oh, good. Well, do you think a couple of them probably get everything started off merrily? I think.
For what? What are we trying to do?
Burn the bodies.
Why would we burn the bodies? They have so many secrets to tell us. Did you see how they didn't even feel pain? I would love to.
Yes, that's why I have blood samples. Nanomachines.
So you're the only one that saw the reaction in the eyes.
Yeah.
There, Einar. So your guess would probably be that it was cybernetics rather than nanomachines, but you don't know anything about what would that actually would be.
Nah, yeah. Einar's knowledge of technology is pretty sketch.
I tell you what, we'll open them up a little bit first. How about that?
I don't understand these secrets. Zephyr and Barash are both better at understanding why people's bodies don't die when I shoot them the first time.
Okay, well, we'll just have a cursory look. I'm just going to sort of like slice the guy's face off with my sword slash knife.
Yeah, you see under his face skin, I guess.
I guess that's what's happening okay, right now.
Do you have, for me, actually I have your page up. Let's see if you got anything in here that would work.
Band has found like a old Sunday newspaper that actually has the comic section and like a little coloring section.
Yeah.
I've got education and general knowledge or...
Nope, not going to help you. Not going to help you. You would need like surgery and or cybernetics in order to do this. AKA Brash.
Yeah. I'm also going to just text Dante. I'm going to text Dante right now too and be like, okay, boss, turns out I was just after Winston. Probably because he got those planes at the Biotechnica place that the animal, not animal, bombed out.
I text back Metal Gear Solid exclamation point over the guard head emote.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sure. Yeah.
I'm not following.
All right. Don't worry.
Okay. All right. So, I mean, you could fuck around in this body as much as you want. Astrid.
Start off the roof.
You won't get anything out of it. You do not have...
Okay, I just sort of hacked this guy for a bit, and I'm just like, ugh, oh, this is so messy. Look, just burn them.
I regret everything that I just did.
I'd like a quick scene of us on top of the small warehouse. It's like one story, we throw the off, it's just like, thump. Like, oh, that's just not very satisfying at this point.
No, we burn them! God damn it. It's like, you know, nobody else is helping, so I'm just, like, shoving them into the fucking incinerator myself and just, like, grenades!
Yeah, you can throw them into an incinerator pretty easily at some point, so...
Right. It's right. A struggle. I'm just like, will you help me? Fucking men. Ugh.
Yeah. So, technically speaking, what do you guys want to do now? Like, what's the next course of action here? I mean, you've got some information from these guys that they're after Weston.
Well, I assume we'd want to, like, just call Biotechnica. Be like, what the fuck?
Hey, guys, why are you doing this?
Seriously.
Oh, I think guys. That's what
Dante would do. Dante doesn't fuck around.
I say we go back to the apartment and I need a shower. I really need a shower. Mm-hmm. I'm basically up to the elbows in blood right now, just using some wet wipes to like... Do you have any more of these?
Cutbacks. They only give one now.
That's awful.
I agree.
Yes.
As we're standing over the gruesomely murdered bodies of two hired...
Well, the merrily burning gruesomely murdered bodies, because, you know... Mm-hmm. I'm probably using like the discarded trousers to wipe my arms off. Wait, were these yours?
So yeah, you guys head on back. I guess you'll meet up again. And what's the next course of action then?
I really couldn't say. Like, these guys didn't give us a whole lot as far as actionable information.
Yeah, I like when we get back and we go report to Dante, and I'm like, well, I mean, he was everything you could do to a man, really. I mean, he was cutting them and playing annoying music, and
they were augmented with nanomachines.
Are you saying that Ben did something correctly?
It was very impressive.
Yes.
Well, eventually, after we realized that, you know, we said that they weren't going to feel anything and to do noise. Oh my, the most horrible sounds that apparently ever have been made upon the face of the earth.
It was pretty bad even through headphones. I mean, apparently, the one thing that nanomachines don't protect you from is aggravation. Good to know.
So, they can't help me at all. I'm already basically a physically perfect human being.
It's right.
But Ashton just gives you like a look, just like
I think it's not very polite of Biotechnica to be murdering your employees on your rooftops.
Sure, but Weston murdered their employees first.
No, he didn't, actually.
And I explicitly told him not to.
He actually
didn't. No. He said that he did kill them. Oh, no, wait. That was to the knight. Mr. Knight. He said that he didn't leave any... Right?
Yeah, he didn't kill them.
We all know he fucked up.
Yeah, but someone knows that he killed people and someone doesn't.
So, I pat Band Morta on the head and hand him a Toblerone bar.
Shit, son!
A big one or a little one? Like, what are we doing?
A little one. We're working our way up.
So not like the Christmas Toblerone.
Yeah, you've done good. And you should be rewarded.
Thanks, boss.
Now get back to work on that computer stuff.
Can I eat my Toblerone first?
Yes. I assume you can computers and Toblerone at the same time. I'm front of this diva who can raise her APM while consuming both Mountain Dew and Doritos.
That's amazing.
One day you will have to teach me how to raise my APMs.
Okay, boss. All right, I gotta go check in with some of my hacker buddies about getting into the.
That's true.
The files there.
If you get back to them, there's a whole message board of responses waiting for you.
Sweet. So I'm gonna go through and reply to people. Be like, the date's coming up soon. I'm gonna let you know as soon as we're ready to go and I have the portal open. is there any specific...
Get in the hole.
Yeah, I tell
it's like a fucking
we don't want
Stargate.
Anyone to fucking Leroy Jenkins this and fuck it all up.
Yeah, all right. So they know what's on the line. They're willing to. So in case anyone's wondering, this is the hacking attempt to try and get to siphon Biotechnica's funds, basically, or at least give you a gateway to get into their secured shit. And, in fact, we probably have enough time to do that, if you wanted to try that.
Yeah.
I feel like the first half of the show is basically me and Astrid passing the torch, trying to get these guys to talk. But, yeah, I think
and then Dan Dambleton goes, oh, play you some music!
I feel like the last portion being Ben's hacking stuff is completely appropriate.
So, I mean, it's pretty open, essentially, right? I'm trying to remember what DC I had set for this thing.
I think it was, wasn't it the DC that I set?
Yeah, it was. It's DC 25 to try and find Inferno AI. That's what you wanted to do, right? You wanted to find the Inferno AI?
Because I have to change avoid detection to avoid detection of non-portal users.
Yeah.
And I have to grant financially. Yeah, I have to grant.
And then there was
shit.
Also, it was the place had had core 6, but they also had a security team. Which means that there was... All right, let's open that up and get that page going. Which means
that was I was gonna have one chance against the security.
Yeah,
team, but
one chance, of DC 25. But as long as you can remain undetected, you won't get caught. And the whole idea is that these extra hackers in the system would give you sort of a distraction, essentially, before you get found out. So, how many people are you bringing to the ballpark here?
We probably have you want to whittle it down to 10 people or something that are actually good enough to affect.
It comes down to essentially how many people you trust.
Yeah.
Right, because this sort of maneuver, if you're setting it in a couple of days, right, to get everyone ready and stuff, it's a case of how easy is that information going to leak? Right?
So we probably keep it in between people that only people that both I and her name? Blast. Mm-hmm. So if like Blast knows the person and trusts them, and I do, then we'll like clone them in.
Okay, let's see. What is your luck? Sorry, I'm just going to take a look here. Okay, so it's 5. So I'm going to say for every 2 people you bring in, you'll get... your luck will go down by 1. So it'll make it harder to pass a luck check. So if it's just you and... Smash?
Blast.
You and Blast, then you don't have to make a luck check. If it's you and Blast and 2 other people, you'll make a luck check at your current. And then 2 more, it's -1. So you can go all the way up to 10, I guess.
Yeah, so...
No, you go all the way up to 8 before your luck is at a 1, so...
Okay, so I need to get below a 4?
No, you need to get a 5. Yeah, if you take 4 people, you need to get a luck. Your luck will be at a 4, so you need to roll less than a 4. Or 4 or less.
Okay, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to bring in a team of 4, and then me and Blast.
Okay. Rolling me a luck check.
Where's the... 2.
Okay, good. Yeah, so everyone is, like, professional, you know? They don't, like, you don't hear anything about it on, like, the boards elsewhere, you know? You set up, like, some sort of, like, notification if any keywords come up, but you don't see anything coming up, so which is good, you know? People have kept their word, and they've kept their mouth shut for the most part. So D-Day rolls around. The idea is that... you will open up a login portal for everyone to use and come in and just sort of like destroy the inside of this place and make it wreak as much havoc as possibly can. In terms of like the money, that the idea is that they're coming in there to siphon money, and they're trying to do it as quickly as possible, right? So your intent here is to get access to the internal locked substructure. And to your secondary objective, I guess, was also to find the Infernal AI.
And see if I can wrangle find the AI
control again. Hmm. All right. So the DC for you have essentially 5 attempts. No, you have 6 attempts because you got yourself included. So you'd have 6 attempts here. The DC is 25. And if you can't do it, you will get essentially locked out and tracked, because their security team is pretty good.
Okay, and what's the skill roll?
The skill roll would be your interface, yes.
Okay, here goes. So we're like on the board. I like jump on the board, and we're like, I'm like, all right, he's go time. We're going to fill our pockets with cash and empty theirs. And then like everyone's like, let's go. And it's all the like cheesiest little icons that you can imagine of like...
Well, it's actually more like you all plug in and you all see each other's avatars.
Oh, because they got gear. Yeah. All these guys got fucking gear. Yeah. So everyone's like hanging out in cyberspace.
Yeah.
High-fiving and shit.
Yeah, so, I mean, maybe one of them is like... What does your avatar look like? I mean, this is the first time we've sort of seen you from the perspective of someone else, right? So,
God, he's probably like a spaceman.
Like a big, bulky spaceman?
Like, yeah, like kind of like Tron, but bulky. Like cross between Tron and like a space marine.
Okay. Yeah, there's probably like one of them is probably like... like Blast is probably like a bomb with sunglasses on. And there's probably a guy there who's like a unicorn or something like that. But it walks around on hind legs and it has a machine gun or something. Like, you know, there's just like just really dumb shit like that. And you essentially, it looks like what you'd imagine, right? You sort of like rip open this sort of like Doctor Who style, like
fucking... The actual portal that I've set up. Yeah.
Maybe you make it look like a fucking Stargate or something like that. Like, and then you all jump through it. And the moment you guys get through, it sort of just looks like a giant like city. The
the blocks of information are all like towers, right? Everyone sort of runs off, and it's almost the way that I want to describe it, and it's probably not anywhere remotely like this in the book, but I want to describe it like this because fuck it, man, it's my game, I can do what I want. Have you ever seen like Godzilla versus any monster where they like wreck a town? So yeah. Everyone grows to like the size of these towers, and they just stomp around the town and like start kicking over towers and stuff like that. Like, it looks like a monster movie, right? So
it's like, what was that game where you'd like punch the buildings down?
Oh, Rampage?
Rampage, yeah.
Yeah.
They're just going Rampage on it, on the whole fucking server.
Yeah, so they're basically looking, they're like, some of the towers are like harder, and like as you hit them, like pixels fly off of them and they change color. Like, you know, it's kind of like a health bar of like a color scheme. So like bright green means like they're healthy, and red means like they're almost dead. And then when they die, they like break up into a million pixels. And inside of those containers is like the information files. And it looks just like, it looks like a video game basically. Cause essentially it is.
Okay. I'm like looking for the like telltale particle effects of the AI.
So you want to go for the AI?
Inferno.
Because you basically, you have six roles you can make here, right? So in order to find the AI, that's DC 25, and also to pass the where they keep all their secret files, right? The big tower surrounded by like essentially a fence of you know, a data fence essentially. It looks like a barrier.
It's like the Matrix fence.
Yeah. So there's that as well. That was the other thing you wanted to get. And that's also a DC 25 as well.
Okay. Well, I think that's kind of like our primary mission. So I will do that first.
Okay. So give me a roll.
All right. Let's do this fucking thing. Oh my God. 25.
What are the odds? So yeah. What the fuck
are you rolling tonight?
So maybe it's one of those things where in the background we see like a digital cobra with like a leather jacket on as one of the avatars that came in with you. He basically like this thing comes down from heaven. It's like a giant like sort of it's like a leaf but with like arms and legs, and just comes down and smashes into the server and basically just like takes this snake and holds it above his head and just. Rips him in half, sort of thing. And then, like, maybe we get, like, a message. Like, you get a message in, like, your overhead display, and it's just, like, chronic disconnected. Yeah. So, you kick down this, this barrier to get into this this portal thing here. So essentially it's going to take a bit of time to like reduce the health essentially of this node in order for you to get through it. So you can speed it up by, it's gonna take two turns essentially because that's what all the nodes take. So you see like Blast and like the Unicorn Man like working on like an infrastructure where they keep all the money. It's basically just like, it looks like a bank in like pixel form, right? And they're like both like sort of kicking and punching this thing,
yeah,
and like maybe, doing like command maze like, and shit like that on, you know, like
I'm like support character. I'm making sure that like no repairs are getting done and like you know,
yeah,
keep, you know, just like bashing all the other bits into smaller bits.
Yeah. You can speed this up and make it one turn by passing another DC 25 check. It's not going to harm you if you fail, but essentially you've got essentially 6 minutes, right, to do this. So, you know, the first minute was you, like, beating down this fence. You're going to spend the next 2 minutes, like, getting through this, essentially, tower.
All right.
Or you can reduce it by passing DC 25. Okay, you're pretty close. But, yeah, you spend this turn doing it, maybe the giant leaf robot thing, like, he picks up, like, you know, he sees another avatar in the corner, and maybe this one's like a, it's like a, I don't know, like a joystick or something like that, but it's got, like, really big, like, muscly arms and legs, just, like,
and like they get into the two hands like wrestling style thing where they're like pushing against each other. Then the leaf like basically like headbutts this controller and then elbows him in the ground sort of thing, like does an elbow drop on this fucking controller, and then you get another notification that says Crytek has disconnected, and you know you're sort of like you can see the health of this node going down to red now. What does your attacks look like, by the way? Are you just shooting a machine gun? Like what are you doing?
I have like a space ray that like blasts off from like a thing up on my wrist. Someone was Captain Ragtag posted some stuff. I don't know if you saw that link, but I was thinking that's pretty damn accurate, like suit number 4.
Okay, yeah. You're like a Judge Dredd or whatever, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. So you're just shooting these laser beams, and maybe you're doing like a Mega Man charge up, and you're just shooting off a big one. Yeah. So you spend this turn, the next turn, like sort of whittling down this big tower. And essentially what happens is it sort of breaks away, and inside it's basically just like this folder icon. It's also got like a lock on it, but you can take the folder with you, right? You can just grab it and put it into like your data deck or whatever. So the third turn comes by, and the big robot thing, leaf thing, he spies the third target. And this one's like a... It's sort of like a skateboard with like flames coming off of the back of it, but it's standing still.
Is it like an anthropomorphic skateboard?
Nah, it's just sort of walking around. It's
cruising around.
It's just walking. It's like it had legs. Have you ever seen like a game where they like... The best way to describe it is, you know, Saints Row 4 when he goes into the hacker space and the guy turns him into a toilet? And it doesn't have any arms or legs, but it moves like it does have arms and legs. So it's like that, essentially. Okay. Except it has fire coming off. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it just sort of wiggles a little bit. And basically, he just picks him up and he, like just sort of does the skateboarder thing of, like, trying to crack the skateboard on the ground. And, the classy skater disconnects. It's SK8.
Maybe I have a quick glance over at Blast, like a worried look.
Yeah, so essentially what's happened here is those two have like whittled down this massive node, like the bank node, and they've started basically like essentially they've both like put these like electrical cables into this like file, and they've started like it's you know the stereotypical like big ball going down the pipe being like,
yeah, there's like a spigot, and then like chunk by chunk, it goes out.
Yeah,
like in discrete units.
Yeah. So what's your next move? I mean, you're trying to find. You got three more turns here. Are you trying to find the AI?
Yeah, I need to find the AI and change some of its instructions.
Narratively, how do you look? How do you try and search in this big city? Do you King Kong up a tower and try and search?
Yeah, I'm like climbing up the tower, but then also doing like leaping boosts with like my like jet powers.
Yeah,
finally like clamber up. And I probably programmed the AI with like some type of
spectral trail. Yeah,
right. No, it would just have like a special icon, and I would assume that that would be like a part of the AI, and it would maybe. You know, have.
I imagine it's kind of like just like a fire or something like that.
Yeah.
Like
so I had like a fire icon. Fire. So I think that maybe that's part of its like personality. So I'm looking like, is there like a bonfire or like a pillar of fire? Or...
Sure. Give me an interface roll. We'll see how well you do.
Yeah.
So you spy like over, past the. Just past the green leaf robot, like behind him, you see like this sort of like, it's sort of like this little tiny like ASCII fire icon just being like, whoosh, like smoking across the thing, and like this big snake like fire trailers behind him sort of thing, and he's just cruising around this space. So what do you want to try and do? You want to try and catch up to this thing and wrestle it? Like, what are you doing?
Inferno, I am your father.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to go try to catch it.
All right. So as you're doing that, the green leaf guy, he grabs the fourth avatar, and maybe this one's like
hasn't he not got the unicorn?
No, that's the last two. Yeah. So the one of the avatars is like he's running around and like the. He's like a tower, like a barracks or something like that, where they keep all the information of people within Biotechnica. And this guy, it's like a... I don't know, what's another good avatar? Fuck, I'm so bad at coming up with these things. It's like a polyagonal guy, like it's bright red, and he's got like the Kanye West sunglasses on. Like, you know, the blue, this lion stripy thing. And he's just sitting there just like... roundhouse kicking over and over and over again, just like the same roundhouse kick over and over again, this tower. And the leafy green guy runs up and basically like just punches him in the face, and his head just goes and shatters into like all these different pixels and stuff like that. And then you see Red Man has disconnected. So yeah, that's four of your six. So and now it's just the two, the unicorn and Blast left, and the green leaf runs over and engages in combat with those two.
Okay, can I, unless Inferno is going to take a turn?
No.
Can I like superhero landing in front of Inferno?
Yeah, just like fist on the ground, like yeah. Yeah, sure. Yeah.
I look up, what does Inferno look like? Like, what did he turn?
So, the draw distance on this thing is kind of like, at a distance, it's just an ASCII icon. But yeah. When you get within, like, rendering distance of this thing, which is, like, you know, literally the closest it could possibly be, it's essentially just like a skull that has a big wheel underneath it, like a unicycle wheel. But it's, okay. Like, the unicycle wheel is, like, inside of the skull sort of thing, so, like... If that makes any sense, like it just sort of...
It's like right at the bottom, it can roll along.
Yeah, basically. And it's like on fire as well. And it just looks at you angrily. So...
Okay.
Yeah. In order for you to reprogram this thing, you do need to pass the DC 25 check. So you want to reprogram it once, right?
Let's see where it is. Where's my notes? Yeah, so...
So right now I've got, for the Infernal AI,
Void detection, open backdoor, and create super user?
Yeah, void detection, DC 25 is what you want to change, yeah?
No, I'm going to do... the old plan. I'm going to... From create super user ban Morda, I'm going to change that to purchase all product stock of Monsanto JoJo Corporation.
Yeah, I've got purchase all stock from Monsanto JoJo, grant financial account super user permissions from internet portal users. Okay, yep. Okay, so that's which one do you want to replace?
I'll replace the create super user.
Okay, so purchase all stock from Monsanto JoJo. Okay. Okay, sure.
25. Yes, 27.
So maybe like it's like he tries to like we get the sound effect of like a motorbike spinning its wheels sort of thing on the ground, and it like rams into you, and maybe you just grab it by its skull and like maybe I don't know. You tell me how do you visually?
Oh yeah, no, he's okay. So he's not like just subservient, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, he like rolls straight at me, and I like jump on him and tackle him, and then I have like a data cord that comes out of my wrist, and I'm like trying to like plug it into a port in the back of his skull.
Futile.
So as you're trying to do that, it like grows super large, like stupidly big. It's kind of just like, you know, the how the Power Rangers go from like being Power Rangers to like having the guy like grow like yeah, it's like it's kind of like that. And like the like maybe you have like some sort of soundtrack going on in your head, and it's just yeah. like
I'm like traversing the like cracks in the skull, like
yeah, and you're like hanging on for dear life. You got your hands like hanging on to like something, and maybe you're crawling across the back of the skull as it's like vividly trying to shake you off. But you know, we see like we get an outside shot of you, and you're like Neo from the Matrix shaking about in your chair or some shit like that. And we go back in, and like maybe you're like drooling a little bit out of your mouth, and this thing, it's trying to shake you off so bad, but you're hanging on for dear life. And as you said, you like the port for this cable is so big now, but you change the size of your cable and you just jam this huge cable in. Just like, yeah,
fucking sparks and shit.
Yeah, yeah, I like it. Red flame like licks you as you like, you know, get fucking blasted off this fucking giant motorcycle skull, and you get flung back. In the interim, though, let's see. Give me a luck check. Oof, no good. Yeah, so the leaf like grabs Blast by like the little fuse that she has, and like swings her around like a fucking hammer ball, and like throws her against like the wall of the server, and she just shatters into a million pieces. Then it says Blast is disconnected, and the last guy there is like the unicorn, and he just like turns around and starts machine gunning this guy. You have one more turn in here. Is there anything you want to do?
Yeah, I want to change avoid detection.
Okay.
Even though I probably won't come back in here, I'll try to avoid detection from non-portal super users. So that would exclude me, as I am the portal super user, from being.
So what do you want to do? Avoid detection from what?
Portal super users.
Well, you don't have a portal anymore. You replace that.
Oh, it's gone. Okay, so I'll just you know what? Fuck it. That's fine. It's gonna creep. It's gonna buy all the stocks. I don't need to fuck around.
Okay. So you're going to what? Leave without detection now in your next turn?
Yeah.
Okay, I can get down with that. So tell me how do you like exit this thing? Like the last guy, the unicorn Joe is like sitting there like machine gunning this green leafy monster. And he's sort of pushing him back, and like maybe he's like the guy's like sort of just holding up his hand. It's like there's sort of like virtual blood just going off his arm and stomach and stuff like that. And he does like the Hollywood reload of like, you know, he's got his machine gun. He throws it up, disconnects, and like he holds his gun upside down. The magazine lands in it, and he cocks the rifle, and he shoots it upside down. Then he flicks it around and shoots it upright. You know, Hollywood. So what are you doing? How do you get out of here? Do you jump out the same portal? Like, how do you do that?
Yeah, I have to, can I like throw a program together on this turn that'll like a program that's like a jet speeder that'll speed me out of here?
I mean, like you can sort of like build one if you want.
It'd be like a programming role, right?
Yeah, sure.
There's broken like pixels everywhere from everything being smashed. And so I can just like with the code that's lying around, like slap something together and ride it the fuck out of here.
Okay. Sure, yeah.
21.
Yeah, I mean you can make something. Like it's not as cool as you'd like. Like you have like a program list that you forgot to bring with you or something like that.
So I have like a bicycle with like the big one in the front and the little one in the back.
I'd say it's just a normal looking motorcycle. It's nothing like cool.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe it looks like similar to my real life bike.
It's a moped.
Oh yeah, no, it's a moped for sure. Yeah.
You got to pedal it. Start it.
But it's got like a cool, like, you did manage to put like an exhaust emote sparkle on it, so you got like maybe money coming out of the back or something like that.
Yeah, like just like stacks money that like flap around.
Yeah, like so. Yeah, you drive for the portal that you were in, and just as like a karate kick comes down on Unicorn Joe's neck, and his head just goes pops off, and these digital pixels explode. And as you're jumping through the portal, it says Unicorn Joe disconnected. And you jump through the portal and you come back out and violently rip yourself out of the thing. Do you do anything with like the hardware? Like, what do you do? Do you like break it, or like what's the normal reaction to you jumping out of like a high security thing like that in order to make sure you don't get tracked?
Yeah, there's probably like some kind of like DDoS.
You take all the
burner.
Hard drives and you just drill them.
No, there's probably like a program that I run that like just is designed to burn out everything. So it just like maxes out everything, puts like burns out all the like cabling in the fucking walls and everything.
Nice. Yeah.
You have to the fucking cable man come and reinstall.
Yeah. But yeah, no, you got everything you wanted out of that. You got Inferno AI, which is like, from your judging, like this, the AI is just a monster now. It is just this fucking uncontained like thing. And the reason, like, there's probably a good reason why they haven't been able to do much is because the Inferno AI is just sort of in there using up large cycles, just crazy amount of cycles. Otherwise, you would imagine there'd be a lot more people in there. A lot more, like, a server.
The resources admin. For doing that are being used by the AI, is that what you're saying?
Yeah. So, congratulations on that. That was pretty good.
That was a nice run.
So, yeah, you've got, like, this inside of your hard drive. You got this thing now. And maybe we can leave the episode there for the week.
That was pretty badass.
Yeah.
It felt very Scott Pilgrim-y in my mind.
Yes. Like, yes.
When they do the audio battles or whatever.
Yes. That's exactly what that was. Like, it's a mixture of Reboot. You remember that show?
Oh, fuck.
Oh, my God. The little French girl who took over the internet?
Yeah. Yeah. Reboot and Scott Pilgrim, I guess. So, yeah. I like the idea that hacking is just this fucking, like, unless you're a hacker, you have no idea what it's like in there. You know, like, being an avatar and just running around.
I mean, yeah,
and, like,
remember that? Like, what was that kid's name? Enzo?
Enzo.
Like a little fucking child, and he came back like a grizzled warrior with an eye covered in a guy scope. Oh. And then he met his child self, and he was like, fuck, I've changed. I'm so hard right now. I'm a changed man.
I remember that. That was the weirdest fucking... Yeah.
I remember that shit, too.
Oh, my God, yeah.
Bob was a loser. Enzo was the best.
Yeah, Enzo was the best. Oh, my God.
Hexadecimal, number one.
Oh, my... Fucking stop triggering me.
Direct.
That show was so bad, though. Don't watch it.
Do watch it. They explained so many basic computer processes relevant to the, 1990s?
Oh, man, that was
this awesome. Is how a RAM bus works. We're transferring a program today.
It's like the magic school bus for fucking...
For computers. Yeah, that's fairly accurate.
Yeah,
yep. Nerds.
So, we're gonna go around and do some shout-outs. Let's start off with Dante Fierro. I feel like... You're doing like puppet mastering more than anything in this show, more than most would do, actually. So, yeah, how you doing?
Well, you know, I occasionally watch Fuzzy in the mornings now and then mock her for all the horrendous humane
Fuzzy in the mornings.
Fucking murder that she performs.
Today, we wiped out an entire peaceful alien village and took all their shit. It was glorious.
I know, I was there. Here's the thing, though. It took me until this morning to figure out that Fuzzy really likes spiders, and that, I mean, I knew that for a while, but because I first started watching her when she was playing Subnautica, I assumed that her channel icon was like a ship's
like steering wheel. And this morning I was like, wait, that's a web. That's a spider web. That's not a ship steering wheel.
Yeah, I have all the cool since
spider.
I use my Twitch
spider.
Thanks, Fuzzy. Thanks.
I got all the fuzzy emotes. See,
if you like watching Fuzzy, you can find her at twitch.tv/fuzzyfreaks.
I kind of got a spider thing going on.
Yeah. All right, I'm done. I'm waiting for the stream that I watch. Apparently.
All right. Awesome. So let's hand it over to Mr. Shaving with the combat knife himself, Mr. Typical GM. How you doing, sir?
Hey guys, it was fun talking about torture today, and how unrealistic our torture methods were, aside from the audio torture that
actually Don worked. So let me give you an idea what you guys were facing here. So they actually had a lot of cybernetics to deal with, specifically, you know, not getting tortured, as it turns out.
Bastards.
And I just like when I like these elite soldiers, these are directly from the book, right? I did not change anything about them. This is what they have. These are like,
that's why it's so easy to kill them.
Yeah. So these guys have a thing called a pain editor, which means they can literally shut off all pain receptors in their body, which is what the little green thing was. So
bastards.
Yeah, so for them it was
what,
like,
about pleasure though?
He was just a homosexual. Like, that's why that didn't work.
See, I could have turned into a bloke, but it would have taken 2 days.
Yeah. But you know, and you guessed right about his infatuation with his teammates, so good job on that.
That was
it worked for the Greeks and the Macedonians.
Yeah.
I don't know about the Romans.
And the Spartans. Well,
they're Greek.
Yeah, I know. Well, yeah, they were a collection of city-states, and, you know...
Collection of Greek city-states, located in the Grecian peninsula.
So, what game... What
commonly
game,
more known as Greece.
What games are you running these days, typically?
I'm running Curse of Strahd, D&D 5th edition, on Saturdays. I'm running my open viewer game on Wednesdays. And right now I'm playing a bunch of bullshit, like Heroes of the Storm and Rust and H1Z1 on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Man, I really miss 5e. Like running a 5e game would probably be pretty impossible for me. But
running 5e is the easiest thing I've done in the past 10 years of tabletop gaming.
Well, I understand that, but like for me, running a game is less about like knowing intrinsically the rules, but more about knowing the world. And 5e for me, like all the gods and shit, it's just like. But for Cyberpunk, it's like, yeah, like the world is like pretty solid in my mind, you know, and
sure.
Definitely makes it a lot easier to do that shit. But man, I just miss like. Okay, did I level up? Sweet. Now I got this. Now I can use this. I miss that. I miss that part.
I'm currently playing a cleric in a 5e game.
Huh. Yeah, 5e is very easy to grasp. It's very easy to get into, both as a DM and as a player. People who are just getting started with tabletop RPGs, I would highly recommend it. For the experienced player, it can be somewhat lacking in sophistication of development. But again, that's really more of a...
Yes, but then you get fun with min-maxing and multi-classing and taking all the random bullshit that you'll never think you'll need and then making it a thing.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to do that kind of stuff, then I'd highly suggest something like Pathfinder if you want to play in a high fantasy setting for min-maxing and like, I want to take 13 one-level dips.
I remember when I joined Arthur's game as a level, what was it, level 18? Was it 18 or 15? It was something high level. I think it was 15, actually.
It was like 12 or 13.
Yeah. And I remember having to like, all right, so what do I have? Oh, I have everything. Oh, I'm just going to pick one class and stick to it. And you know, he was pretty cool. I still have that picture of him sitting on a chair.
With cats on his head.
With the cats everywhere. Yeah. That was a good picture. Yeah, absolutely. All right.
Speaking... Not like the other boys. You're a tiefling.
I'm tiefling. That's right.
Ugh, tieflings. They're so emo.
Yeah.
Well, actually, he wasn't that emo. He was like, why does everyone hate me? I don't understand.
Oh,
like,
oh,
he was like, why doesn't anyone love me? Not that emo.
It was Asia. It was Asia. It was weird. It was a good game. Anyway, Fuzzy, what's up? How you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm currently sort of dead. Also, look. While the hacking was going on, I drew a thing.
Oh,
I'm quite adorable. Proud of it.
That's like that's almost like a Isaac, Binding of Isaac style creature.
Yeah. Kind of, yeah. I don't know. I just did a little chibi spider thing because I can draw and listen at the same time. So it was better than reading Twitter and just being like, "What, the game's ending?" Which I have a tendency of doing. Anyway, yes. So, yay! Hi, I'm Fuzzy. I do things. Tomorrow. I'm really excited because the Marin is coming out for Sun the Sea and it's submarines in a deep dark ocean under the planet, which for some reason has something to do with hell, and it's all really weird, and I'm really looking forward to it.
You see a monster with infinite eyes. What do you do?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Don't blink.
Yes, and don't go near the Dawn Gate. Because the sun is bad.
Awesome. I wish it had multiplayer. It would wreck the game, but...
Well, it definitely wrecked the game, but yeah. Sort of Fall in London, but that's not really multiplayer either, so...
Hmm. Speaking about wrecking the game, let's talk to the man who managed to hack Biotechnica. Mr. Van Morta, yeah. AKA...
You had a good fucking roll, like, the dice love you tonight.
You rolled three crits in a row.
Yeah, I was rolling hot fire tonight. Man, almost all my, all my hacking. Ah, it went beautiful. That was fun. God, I love this game. It's so good. So thanks, everyone, for coming to watch us play it, because I love performing for all of y'all out there on the internet. And make sure to come back if you're around tomorrow night, because there'll be more fun roleplay.
Carrying company. Yeah.
I'll be like trolling people with magic. You can basically guarantee it.
Oh boy. Yeah. Forgot about that.
If you want to check more of my stuff, you should follow me over at twitch.tv/zircon5, because I'll be like hosting people, for instance. On Wednesday, I'll be hosting AP Gaming Real as I battle in a mech against the denizens he sends against me.
Oh, no. It's not a GM versus players game. I will also be a player.
Then I'll just try to avoid being backstabbed and killed.
No, my friend, I'm going to take you to a dance. Then we're going out for dinner. We're going to have a conversation, and then we're going to fight in our mobile frames.
That sounds like a good plan, though.
Yeah, it does sound like a good plan, right?
Dinner and a mobile Gundam fight, anyone?
Of course, old chap! Make sure to get the salmon tartare.
Oh, look, we're getting raided at the end of the show. So, like I was saying, twitch.tv/zircon5. I mean, even if you just tuned in, look at that mustache. Just look at it. You want more, you can get more at twitch.tv/zircon5.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and... hey, Brosaders, how you doing? Welcome. Sorry you caught the end of this. But yeah, thank you very much for watching. If you haven't already, please consider hitting that follow button. It really helps us out. Trying to do everything that we can to help grow what we do here. So Nightcity, as we know it, is going to be coming to a close next week. Will be the final episode for this arc. We'll have to have a chat afterwards to how you guys wish to end it. But essentially what's going to be happening is our dear friend, Mr. AP Gaming Reels, last episode will be next week. The week after, he goes on holiday, so we can't grab him. And the week after that, it will be Halloween. So I can't expect anyone to jump in. But we might have a Nightcity Stories arc that we can play on both of those days. I'll see what I can do about that. I might be able to convince Eric Valgaris to come in and play the Cyberpunk 2020 Olympics episode that I want to do. But yeah, we'll see how that goes. And then after that,
we're going to be starting up Nightcity Lowlife, which is the exact same game, the exact same world, the exact same story. Everyone will have brand new characters, and we'll be introducing a new player. I'm going to get a name completely wrong here. Is it Tessa Chunka? Is that how you say it, Fuzzy?
Muted.
Well, anyway, we're bringing her.
Sorry, Tessachka, I think.
Tessachka? Okay.
I always get it wrong as well, but yes, Tess.
Tess. We're bringing yeah. Tess in. She is going to be taking over the role of Arthur, and she's going to be making a character with everyone else on the 7th of November. That's when that starts. So that's going to be really fun. And yeah, let's talk about Die Party for a second here. So Die Party has 4 active games. We are going to be closing down one of them. So tomorrow, on Mondays at 5 p.m. PST, we have Die Party Nightcity, which is this game. Hope you enjoyed it. Power Ranger references and all the likes. It was a good episode. That and burning penises, but that's the point.
Cocks were sucked today.
Yeah, that's true. Tuesdays at 5 p.m. PST, we have Die Party Carrying Company, which is basically Dungeon World. It's basically Dungeon World now. Game about it's sort of basically like the Black Company. You know, it's Mountain Blade with criminals, basically. on Wednesdays we have this week we have the final episode of Die Party Iron Saddle. We're bringing it to a close because I literally cannot handle GMing 2 games a week and working 11 hours a day. So, you know, that's on me. It's on no one else. But we hopefully will be replacing that pretty soon. so we will still have 4 games. I just won't be GMing it. Go figure. And then on Thursdays at 5 p.m. PST, we have Die Party Fulcrum, which is a Mutants and Masterminds game where we don't pick our powers. Yay. Fuzzy, you've left that game now, right?
Yeah, I sort of like basically got written out. Oh, but then the game didn't go ahead. But did the game go ahead?
No, it didn't.
Last week? No, but yeah, we were going to basically write me out last week. So it'll... But yeah.
So hopefully we'll have a new player by then to fill that spot. So... we have in mind who it's going to be. I just don't want to say it in case it doesn't come to fruition because, you know, that's how you jinx things. And that's pretty much it. Tomorrow we have Board Games with Beta Bros as per normal. That we'll be playing... we'll have Distracted Elf on and we'll be playing...
tomorrow or Wednesday?
Wednesday. Wait, what's today? Today's Tuesday.
Monday.
Sorry. Yeah, oh, Wednesday. It's Wednesday. We'll have Distracted Elf on. We'll be playing Pandemic, actually. So that'll be fun. Get hyped for the worst fucking virus name in the world. I have a feeling it's going to be something disgusting, but that's just the game. So, yeah. Anyways, guys, that's pretty much it. Thank you very much for watching. And remember, if you get captured by Einar, say goodbye to your ding-dang. Bye-bye.